that, I think we are good to go. Hopefully, maybe. Don't actually know. I tried turning the volume down because I think it was going bad again. All right, down, down, up, right, left, up, down. You hear that? Okay, that's weird. Every now and then there's like this click. You guys hear that? Hang on, do we hear it in game? Alright, I'm gonna do something stupid. Right, hang on just a second. Hang on. Hang on just. Okay, for a second I thought I was out of sync. Oh no. Capture device not found. Alright, let's close out of this program. Oh no! Now you'll see behind the scenes. No! I cannot allow this. You are not allowed to see behind the scenes. You may notice that the game is much louder all of a sudden. Okay, hold on. Let's try that running test again. Okay, so. Alright, so. Right, up, down, down, left, up, right. Up. Okay, good. So, maybe it was just my imagination, but I swear I was hearing, like, a little, like, every now and then. But it would appear that we are all sorts of ready and good. Today's stream gonna be a little bit weird. It's, it's a bit earlier than I stream normally, because I have engagements in the evening. But that is all well and fine. This week, streaming-wise, is gonna be weird in general, so, you know, don't. It's gonna be a little bit weird. I'm not gonna try to worry too hard about it. I hope no one else does. And with that, yeah, we're all good. Look at my little baby. Look at my adorable little baby, Pseudosnoot. Hold on, let's see if I can position him right. Hang on. There we go. You're both looking at the camera. Let us properly begin. Hello everyone, my name is Max, this is LordEctro. Welcome back to Pokémon SoulSilver. Well, it's a Nuzlocke, but something I forgot is to bring up my Nuzlocke rules. Alright, SoulSilver Nuzlocke, let's switch it to the desktop view. There we go. I know the green screen. Fix yourself. Fix yourself. Almost. But, just as a quick reminder of the rules, I'm gonna just rapid fire go down them. Alright, so, traditional Nuzlocke. The first Pokemon you find in any route is the only one you can catch, which is why you see I have this list here. If the Pokemon faints, it is considered dead, and all Pokemon must have nicknames. I added a bunch of, like, contingencies and clauses, of which include... what's it called? The Doubles Clause, which includes evolutions. If evolution requires a specific gender, I'm allowed to take it, unless there's, like, evolution for each gender. The Gen 1 clause, which is basically if I just don't want a Gen 1 Pokemon, just straight up. HM slaves are allowed. Catching shinies, the rules are broken. All legendaries must die. If I'm required to catch them, then all rules are suspended after I kill them once. I'm allowed one team mascot, who I chose to... Oh, I just realized the Zerg is on here, but that's because of my desktop form. The team mascot I've chosen before even starting the game. Oh, Mac, it's good to see you. But the one mascot... Yeah, just as a recap of the rules. The one mascot I chose, which you can see on the other side of the screen over there, is Slowpoke, which we might be getting this episode. Hopefully, maybe. And yeah, that's just generally what we're doing. It's our goal, not in any particular speed or in any particular style, to get my stylus. Wait, hold on, netball. Ooh. I want a netball. Okay, what can I sell? Escape rope, potion, flash, chesto berry? I'll sell the X accuracies. I don't know about you guys, but I never use X accuracies or like anything of that sort. I never use them because it always feels kind of cheating. We have like no money. Hey, we got like 5 potions. Let's do like 2 more. And then we got like, yeah, we're good. We're good as far as I'm concerned. It's all good. I'm ready to crush the first gym with Lyra the Mareep. Remind me again, where the fuck did you get a Mareep? I didn't get a Mareep unless it was like a morning Pokemon kind of a deal. Actually, I lied. I think I'm never gonna talk to that guy. Okay, so we're gonna be dealing with. Does it tell me what kind of gym this is? Like, I don't want to cheese it too hard, but, this is a flying gym, right? Faulkner, the elegant master of flying. Yep, okay, cool. So, from Route 32. Ah, okay. I think that's where we got Chidane, isn't it? Route 32? Hold on. No, I haven't been to Route 32 yet. What? Where's Route 32? What? You have secrets that I don't, Mac? Where are you getting? Hang on, Pokecube? Where are you getting this map? Where is this route 32? What? Do we have access to Route 32? Go down from the store. Oh my goodness, we have access to Route 32. Oh yeah, that's right, because I wanted to run this way. Oh my goodness, I could have had a whole nother... Let me guess, you're going to stop me? Man, fuck you, man. Alright, so... Here's the debate in my head. Will I get different Pokemon if I go further? Alright, but I really... Golem Mareep actually sounds pretty good. Honestly, just like a solid lightning type, that'd be amazing. Gimme that shit. Gimme... Alright, here we go. Let me write this down. Route 32. I kinda wanna invoke Gen 1. I kinda wanna invoke Gen 1. And I'm saying this, I'm gonna invoke Gen 1. The Gen 1 rule. Solely, not because I want a Mareep, but just because I've used Ekans before. No, Joey, bugger off! Yeah, I've used Ekans before. So that's why I'm kinda like, We have a Rattata on the team, so I'm gonna keep pumping this dumb rule of mine. Fuck you. Like, I mean, okay, don't get me wrong, Ekans and Arbok is cool, but like, you know, I've used them before. It's, what, they got Poison Sting and Bite. That's really it. I'm gonna Google and see if there's even anything else on this. Because I am, oh, Max is a Nuzlocke. Yeah, but I'm kind of, oh my gosh, I lived. I'm gonna quick attack your ass. Oh, I forgot to turn on the battle hoojzits. Yeah, my goal isn't to solely cheese for Mareep. How about this? Should I just get any cans? Nah, I'm gonna stick to my guns. I'm gonna stick to my guns. I want a Mareep. Cause Mareeps are dope. Or I just want something that's not neat from Gen 1. Oh, wait, I just made a realization. Hold on. So, because of what we're playing... I'll take it. I'll fucking take it. I'll take it. It's mine now. This is my chance. This is my one chance to get it. Scrutineep doesn't like me. That is completely fair. Okay, so... Okay, so here's a problem, right? I'm not 100% on what won't kill it. Because we're all so much higher level than it. So that's why I'm like... But it's level 6. You know, it's level 6. So that's what I'm kind of thinking. I can try to... I bet if I switch in Mapritka and get one poison sting, I'll be solid. I'm willing to make that bet. I'm willing to make that bet. And you know what? If I lose Mapritka, it's not the biggest thing. Because this, I want a Mareep. A Mareep will be sick. Oh, perfect. My attack fell too. Beautiful. Okay, math. Nah, I'm not going to risk it. I'm just going to... Don't poison. Oh, perfect. Even better. Don't poison. Motherfucker. Motherfucker. Mapritka, what the fuck? You piece of shit. Why? Oh, fucking. You know what? I deserve that, frankly. I deserve that. I deserve it. I was sitting there trying to... By all accounts, that should have been fine. That should have worked. I shouldn't have gotten greedy. I should have switched in. I should have switched in the Bellsprout. I should have switched in Bellsprout, Sleep Powder. It would have been fine. I done goofed. I could have had a lightning type. An honest to goodness, solid lightning type. Ah, yeah. Sadness. I want it back. Alright, so if we're going up against... Oh, yeah, thank you. Thank you for reminding me. Thank you for reminding me. In the zone. Alright, battle scene on. Oh, wait, oops. No, on. Yes. Alright, so... If we're going up against a flying gem, my first instinct is Chidane. But really, Chidane, Woodkin... Actually, yeah, Chidane, Woodkin, and Sudasnoo will all do well in here. I don't want to just walk in and... I don't want to just walk in and just tear it up. Just gonna walk around, you pukes. Heck no, I ain't just gonna walk around, you pukes. I'm fighting all of you. All a great experience. Oh, you can tell what it feels like to be a bird Pokemon. But, what was I just thinking? Yeah, I don't wanna just sweep with, level 9, yeah. Okay, Fury Swipes is technically more damage, technically on average. Ooh, then Quick Attack, yeah. Ooh. Yeah, slash the shit out of you! Say, look. That was pretty good and quick and done. Yeah, I don't want to just sweep with Chidane, even though Chidane is like the clear answer here. You know, let's give some love to everyone else. Let's make sure we're all, you know, tip-top shape. The game doesn't really expect me to be running around with 5 Pokemon, but whatever. Ho-ho! You know the first guy? The first guy was all chill. Overleveled my whole team except for Lyra, so she crushed the gym. Yeah. Sounds like the right thing to do. But, let's do Fury Swipes. You're faster than me. You're level 7 and you're faster than me. That is really impressive. But, okay, so here's a belief I have, and I'm gonna say it right now. It's completely wrong. Okay? This is my belief. If a gym is designed to be one particular type, like this is the flying type gym, they're gonna have something to shut down electric types or ice types or rock types or... I think that's it. Yeah. And like, if they don't have that, they should. Oh, Lyra? Or Lyra. Lyra. Okay, Lyra. I can remember that. So I'm used to seeing it as Lyra.
You peep shake clip flying with the jolt electricity.
Oh, thanks, yeah. See, I bet he has, like, some kind of bird that has, like, a ground type move or something when he says that. Yo, he ain't gonna let me just get away with shit kind of a deal. Alright, we can do this. Man, I could have had a Lyra. I am genuinely bummed. Aw, Kenai, bitch. Yeah, I am genuinely bummed about that. Like, God, I hope I get another chance at a Mareep. I really do, because this Mareep is... I know it's the first gym, but I have very high stamp. I'm scared. Oh, shit. Here we go. Okay, we can try a few of those. But, no, I just, like, I'm not gonna say I have high standards to be like, look at me, I'm so great. It's just like, no, that's just how my mind operates. Oh, this isn't good. This is not good. Okay, yeah, we're switching out. After this, we're switching out. Someone's gonna have to take a hit. I think I will send in... You wanna hit crit? Well, of course you did! You had a freaking Lyra. You had a freaking Lyra. If I had a freaking Lyra, I'd be sending her first and switching into Chidane. And just going fucking ham. Ooh, 9. Okay, noted. So I could take... Well, I could take one crit. Bleh. Ooh, you're still doing... Ooh. Okay, hang on. There you go. Okay. Okay, we're done. We're good. Yeah, Wookin! Yeah, look at you. You're a tanka boy. And yeah, Suda Snoot. Oh, hey, sick. Doesn't it evolve at level 16? Does it evolve at level 16? Alright, we'd be Falconer. Yeah!
Oh! What? Yeah!
Heck yeah, let me get the Cyndaquil. Let me get my little Cyndaquil goodness. No, it's Cyndaquil, it's Quilava. Hey. I did not expect to get Quilava that quickly. I honestly thought it was gonna be a minute. Alright, let's grab Heart Gold. Grab the Imagio, save. Sorry, this is a bit of housekeeping. There's a way to get Mareep Egg in this town, but I don't know if you'd count it. That would depend. How do you acquiesce it? Oops. Shit. How? Is it like a trade kind of a deal? Because if it's a trade, I'm not going to do it. But if it's like they're going to give it to you no matter what, then I'll count that as this town. Actually, wait, no. I didn't have any contingencies. Should we allow trade-ins or gifts? My first instinct is to say no. How about this? Okay, hold on. Let's add a contingency. Hold on. The guy gives it to you if you get some stuff based on your trainer ID. Alright, Riding contingency. Hold on. We need to add a few. Okay, let's see. You're allowed to reattempt to catch Pokemon. This does not apply if there is a specific evolution per gender. There's also a Wooper and Slugma egg.
Okay.
Okay, so my mind is going two ways. No, let's be fair. Hold on. Let's see. You are not allowed to utilize gift or traded Pokemon gained within towns. This does not apply to fossils or similar situations. Cause, okay. Okay, so the min-maxer in me wants to do that and get a Mareep. A Mareep would be tight. It would be so fucking good. Okay, I'm gonna cheat a little bit. I'm gonna cheat slightly. Cause this is more just to kick myself in the gut a little bit. Here we are. Oh wait, hold on. SoulSilver. Okay, so there's more chance. Yeah, there you go. Visit from Primo at Violet City. There's Primo. Oh, that's the guy. Oh. Caught during given away as eggs. Yep, here they are, just like you said. Everything in me wants a Mareep really fucking bad. But I don't think taking the gift Pokemon like this is fair. Which is why I wrote down, you're not allowed to utilize gift or traded Pokemon gained within towns. This does not apply to fossils or similar situations. Yep, I'm gonna keep that. Because me personally, get the fucking Mareep. It will round out our team. It'll be beautiful because with Slowpoke, we have our fire, water, grass, and then we're gonna have a normal, a rock, and a lightning. It'd be Oh, I just realized the text thing is over here. That is not right. Hang on just a second. I gotta fix something. There we go. Let's grab Colava. Back right here. There we go. Good thing we caught that early. That's fine. I'm beating myself up about it. I'm beating myself up about it because a Mareep would be amazing. So that's why when you say you gotta, I'm just like, I'm sad. Roost? You know, can't Beedrill learn Roost? I remember there's some odd Pokemon that don't actually have, Hold on, I got it. Yeah, that's why I'm beating myself up about it. Sad. Oh, nice! So I'm guessing it's actually pretty early on then, if your Saturn evolved. Alright, so they want me to go south, Route 32. Although, if we can go back into, let's go back into... Hey, thanks for your time, man. Thanks for your time, man. I really appreciate it.
We did it! Yay!
Oh god, scary! Screw you. So yeah, if your Sentret evolved, if Saturn evolved, then it should be. Oh my goodness, Professor! Should I count the egg? I kind of want to. Actually, I don't really want to because I bet I know what that Pokemon is. I bet it's a freaking Togepi. And try smash it. There's nothing here. You were just like rocketed. There we go. You were just like rocketed into space on a platform and you fought a bunch of dudes. Aw, no wonder, Big Babu. Big Bebe. Let's see. Yes. I forgot. Where did you say? It's in the Pokemon Center, right? It's in the Pokemon Center. It's like, hey, hang on. Oh, God, I'm sad. It's Togepi, Togetic, and then Togekiss, right? Togekiss is sick. Like, just being 100% honest, Togekiss is just great. An exit. Oh, it said, there was another choice, it said Roughneck. Oh, wait, is it you? The you? Shit. Where do you say the guy with the egg is? Do you say the Pokemart? I was not paying attention. Like, I'm gonna be honest, I was not paying attention. Yeah. Thing is, sure, I'll take care of an egg. Sure. Violet City egg. I'm gonna guess it's a Togepi. Let me just grab my egg icon from Bulbia. Oops. Because that's what we do here. We have a theme. Where's a sprite for an egg? This'll do. This'll do just fine. Then we'll switch over here. Boom. Just set that mess right there. God, I wish I could save the sprites from like Bulbapedia and stuff. That'd be sick. Let's see. Terrified certain probably was farther in the game. Not gonna say when, but it makes me nervous whenever I think about it. Ooh. Let's see. Yeah, Charlton. Yeah, screw you, man. I'm out. But what was I trying to think? Togekiss. Am I about to get mugged? Are you gonna mug me? I'm pretty sure I was just about to get jacked. She's gonna take that egg and book it out, gonna sit here and go, oh well, and walk away. But, yeah, Togekiss, Fairy Flying, super strong special attack, has that one ability that makes its secondary effects are twice as likely to happen. Slap an Air Slash on that bitch. 60% chance to make someone flinch every attack. It's freaking great. I don't think Togekiss is on my main team, but I'd be lying if I said it. Here we go. Runes of Elf. All right, Runes of Elf. What do we got? I don't care, but you're level 11. Throw a muggy. Why? What did I do? I did nothing. Just maybe. You're so fast. Oh, you're so slick and so smooth. Look at you, Geo dude. Too bad. Oh no. All the lightning attacks I was planning on using on you. Oh no. You're dead. I was gonna say, if you live, I will be very impressed. But nope. Yay! That lady was totally gonna mug me, though. Just saying, she was totally gonna mug me. Ah, no worries, no worries. But yeah, Togekisses are great. That I do remember. 100%. Would I want to use one this game? Yeah, maybe. I mean, it doesn't get fairy typing until later, so, you know, maybe not the best idea to... There we go. Stylus. But maybe not the best idea to use it yet until it gets its fairy goodness. But... You know, maybe. I wouldn't be opposed to it. You might live from this. You might. Just for the record. Yeah, we're going up against level 12 or 13 wild Pokemon. It makes me wonder if our team is not as overleveled as I thought it was. A little scary.
Yay!
Alright, okay, there's nothing here either. One more. Yes. Oh, we could also totally go into the, oh, green shard, sick. Is it green shard for... I think it's just money, isn't it? I'll hang on to it, I guess, but I want to say that's like a money item kind of a deal. But, I can't get over there yet because we don't got the surf. We don't got the rock smash. Unless, oh my gosh, there's a door. I did not think that was a door. I honestly thought it was like, oh, I need surf to get over there, but guess not. Yep. All right. It's all good. Oh, it's all Geodudes. Give me a Rogan Rolla, except that's Gen 5. Yeah, Rogan Rolla is Gen 5. Rogan Rolla or... I'd take a Golem. I'd take Golem over a Rogan Rolla, 100%. Just because, if I remember correctly, let me just flex some Pokemon knowledge. Rogan Rollas have an ability that's like weak armor that like the more you hit them, their defense goes down, but their speed goes up. Which objectively is a cool idea, but they're also built to be like physical walls. So it's like this argument, aw, what's wrong? You have sad face. What is going on, Mac? I'm babbling nonsense. Okay, I'm never gonna use it, or not until way later in life. But what was it? Yeah, Rogan Rollas have an ability that basically is, so the more you hit them, their defense goes down, but their speed goes up. And on one side, you can argue, yeah, here's Route 32. Could've had a Mareep. I could've had a Mareep, and it breaks my heart. Sure, let's leave with Woodkin. But, are you gonna freaking stab me? Well, no, okay, so, I'm not saying Rogan Rolla is bad. It's just Rogan Rolla has, like, its ability of weak armor. It has an interesting but kind of backwards logic of its defense is so high that you lower your defense, like, your one good stat to make yourself faster because you're also a good physical attacker. But then you're losing what makes you, what you're good at. But also, you have so much defense, you can risk losing. It's a weird and interesting... The guy was gonna mug me. I'd like to make a general statement for the court, Mac. You suck. Oh wait, no, what am I doing? We go back to the dark, let's go to the dark cave. Yeah, let's go to the dark cave. Yeah, I would like to speak for the court in that you freaking suck. And I don't trash it. And I'm a little hurt, personally. by this that you get to have fucking I don't remember what it's called, but evolves from a sheep. Yeah, evolves from a sheep to a sheep with less fur, but it's bigger, to this weird draconic thing, which is badass, and I want one. And you have one, and I don't, so I'm gonna throw a hissy fit, if you don't mind. Because I'm jealous. Oh, wait, hold on. See, that's sparse. I'm gonna dunce. Okay, so here's the next question. How far can we navigate without using Flash? Because Flash is a one-time use, and I don't want to use it. Oh, what the heck is this thing? It's a rock. Flaffy. Ah, it's a Flaffy. And all, you have a plush, too. It's so freaking cute. Oh, I forgot everything he's level 2. I was about to say, like, you know, I need to be careful and make sure we treat this, make sure we treat this area with respect. The level 2. Watch me give a shit. Alright, well, in that case, let's see. Nope, that's a ledge. This would be so much easier if I used Flash, but I really don't want to. Just simple as that. I don't even want to fight things. Just let me go on my merry way. Just let me go on my merry way. It's fine. Alright, I don't have the money or the means to get a rappel, so I don't care. Also, real talk, if a shiny Geodude shows up, I'm throwing Chidane in the trash. I'm getting the Chidane. I'm gonna call the. Oh, damn it. Oh, hey! Sick. Alright. Oh, ah! Let's see. Oh my goodness, it's a Zubat. I don't even really care. Alright. Oh. This is a little bit of a maze that I'm making for myself because I refuse to use Flash. Kimer could have a shiny buddy. Exactly. Yeah, like, all the hard work I put into Chidane, I would throw him in the ditch if I got my hands on a shiny Geodude. Because I think they turn gold, right? Which is pretty cool. I knew it. I knew it. I freaking knew it. I knew it. I said, I let it be known to the court. I said specifically, the place is going to be blocked off with Rock Smash. I could have added Dunsparce! God, that breaks my heart! I don't even know what they do! It's a tanky motherfucker. Alright, I'm a little intimidated. Is that the one that just raises its attack endlessly? I think it is. Its rage is building. Wait, does its attack go up the more I hit it? Well, that was scary. I'm gonna smash. Oh, damn it. I could have had a what does Dunsparce even do? I wanna say it is literally just normal, some poison, some dragon moves. I think it learns a lot of like odd TMs. Maybe, coil? I think it learns coil. Oh. Hey, sick. Hey, Aether. Doesn't really do me much good, but hey, you know, it's cool. I'll have to take a look at it sometime. I don't really use Twitter that much, and like I followed a bunch of YouTubers I liked, but it's almost all it is always one of two things. Either A, it is people. Actually, no, one of three things. This is my experience with Twitter, which is why I don't really use it. Option one, it's weird trends that people have made up that they insist on everyone following. For example, the And, like, some of them are cool, but, you know, it's like everyone does it solely because the internet tells them to, kind of a thing. I think the last one I saw was, like, redraw Sailor Moon, and it's like, oh, there's some cool art here, but, you know, why are we all doing it, kind of a thing. It's that, people liking and sharing art, and 90% of the time it's lewd. Which, I mean, hey, if that's what you're into. And then the other thing is, like, people just getting really mad about politics. And it's like, ah, great. I need more of this. Yes, this makes me feel good and safe. Tell me more how to think. I'm not saying anything because politics is something I should just stay away from when it comes to the internet. Like, I have opinions, but you know what? I'm an entertainer. I am an average person. It is not my place to share them. And no, that is not me trying to trick you into asking. It's just, I don't want to bring that to this. Screw you, man. Is that the guy that gives you a roar? But, yeah, it's like, I don't want to try to force my opinion on others. You know, their opinion is their opinion. My opinion is my opinion. It doesn't mean anything. Oh, no. I am overleveled. I am overleveled as all get out. And I'm okay with it. Because they put me up against a level like 12 or 13 or whatever freaking Geodude, and that guy scared me. Oh, you're still alive? Impressive. That will do you absolutely no good. At all. I am not getting it might be a connection. Sorry. I'm sorry, man. Yes, I recognize when I say man, it doesn't apply, but like I said, it's how I talk to you. I don't mean any offense by it. But. Yeah, it might help if you, Sorry, just grab something. It might help if you lower the quality of the video. You know what I mean? That might assist with it. But, I'm not sure if there's any settings or... Don't you poison me. If you poison me, I will throw a pretty big fit if you poison me. I'm still bummed. I could have had a Marie. I could have had a Marie. I would have... What would I have named it? Probably... Pushaffers, something like that.
Gotta repel. Gotta repel. My repels are pretty cool.
Alright. This is the first battle I personally instigated. It's like, get off your fucking farm! Slap it out of her hand. Alright, I'm gonna quick attack your butt. Let's see, a Nidoran. I don't think I'd mind a Nidoran. I remember as a kid, Oh, damn it. I remember as a kid, Nidoking used to be... Pardon? I'm getting Woodkin out. I'm getting him out. Sure, Chidane, get in there. Dude, what just happened? Stop it, you little bastard. You little rock throw. Just rock throw. Just fuck you. Okay, we're good. That was weird. That was super weird. But, whatchamacallit? Woodkin! 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 Let me get Fred up. Woodkin! I get to join Saturn. Also, fun fact, did you know that thing is 5'11"? Just want everyone to know that. This beautiful, adorable creature. There we go. This beautiful, adorable creature is 5'11". Now, I assume that's in length. You know what I mean? But it's a big freaking thing. I don't even know what this thing is classified as. It is considered a long body Pokemon. It's like, it's so freaking cute. Oh my goodness. Oh my goodness. Yes, you will be my new girlfriend. No, you won't. Just yeah, sure. Look at this boy! Or is it a boy or a girl? Oh shit, hang on. Oh wow, everyone's a boy except Bidinch. You play hide and seek with Fred and Poke Park curls up when it's hiding. That sounds so, look how good it is! He's so cute! He's so big! Sorry, I'm done. No, I'm not. He's so big! He's a big freaking boy! He's a big boy, look at him! Blap, 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 blap. Oh, is this where I get a fishing rod? Let's switch to... Of my Pokemon, who do I have an emotional attachment with? Bellsprout. I have more of an emotional attachment towards Bellsprout than I do with Mipritka, to be 100% honest. But, dude, give me...
He was so big!
Saturn's cuter, fight me. It's like the thing of, like, I would love a Poliwag. I would adore a Poliwag. Except I'm getting Slowpoke, so who cares? But still, I would adore a Poliwag. But, it's like the thing where, everyone's dog is the best dog and everyone's cat is the cutest cat. It's like all of us with our Furts and Sentrets, which are equally adorable, just being like, mine's the cutest. Except he's like 6 feet long. So, like, this 6 foot long cat just holding it up, like, this is mine's the cute one. Oh, God, that'd be hilarious. Also, you bastard. You don't learn Confusion yet, right? I know Poliwags eventually learn Confusion. That might be Poliwhirl. So I just realized that. It's like, yeah, hang on. This could be really bad. Nah, he's just being. I'm going to draw a Pokemon after this. I don't know. Draw Saturn. Oop, there you go. Yeah, why not? Draw Saturn. Well, actually, I should tell you what to draw. You draw whatever your heart says, but yeah. As an idea, you have no obligation to listen to me.
Yeah, but Inge. Yeah.
God, I forgot. He is shit. He is a mixed fighter like you wouldn't believe. Let's see. I was hoping Bellsprout was going to evolve. Also, Wait, I was going to say, is this the guy that has this all Magikarps? This is gonna be awkward, especially since I was gonna say your Magikarp is probably faster than me, so I'm just gonna have to sit here and watch you splash at me. Yep. There's always one guy who just comes at you with. Oh wait, that guy actually knows Tackle. Oh shit, that thing's on 15. This is your big boy. Oh, nope. And you goofed. And, there you go. Just do that real quick. And, yep, go away. That was a little scary. Let me guess the rest are level 5. Yep, I'm willing to make that bet. I'm betting the rest are level 5. So it's like 5, 5, 5, 15. So, like, you get all confident. And then you're just like, oh, shit. See, unless this one's. Yep, that's exactly what it was. You get confident until you hit the big one, and then you're like, oh shit, this Magikarp's higher level than the gym leader. And then you're like, oh wait, it can only do tackle and has no attack whatsoever. Yeah, I could have got a Poliwag in this. Oh my goodness, Wade, what do you want? Oh my goodness. Oh my. Lyra scared me when she got hit by Mudshot. Yeah, Mudshot is scary. Oh no. This guy's gonna kick the shit out of me. I'm scared. This guy was, he wasn't fishing, he was waiting for. You might know Peck. You might know, this could be bad. This could be bad. And you're faster than me. Ooh, no. Oh, no. This could be bad. This could definitely. Okay, we're good. Goldeens are scary. Like, low-key, they are kind of scary. Poison powder. I'm tempted to bring a Pokemon plush over, but it's like, nope, not gonna do that. Just tie it to my shoulder right here. I might do that later. I would rather have sleep powder is better for catching, but I would rather have poison powder for combat. But more importantly than both of them, I would much prefer Stun Spore. Because Stun Spore, you know, 50% chance permanently that they can't do anything about me. And then just slowing them down. Yes!
Give me a fishing rod, you piece of shit.
That's creepy. Alright, anyway, I'm gonna leave you now. Ooh. I'll fight you, kid. Found some good Pokemon in the grass. You're gonna bring a Mareep. Yeah, bring. I could have had a Wooper. There are Hoppip in the grass. I could have had a Hoppip? What the fuck? I could have had a Hoppip. Hoppips are cool. God, I would have thrown Budinj under the... Right, because in... Yeah, in Gen 2, they have all three of their evolutions, right? And they just become, like, super fast. God, I would have loved a Hoppip. I would have thrown Budinj under the... Gomery! Break my heart. Break... I'm gonna kill you. It's gonna break my heart. Just bye. Yep, you're done. Bye. There's a lot of trainers over here, actually. Yeah. I could have had a Hoppip! No, you freaking fall in a ditch, Bellsprout. I don't want anything to do with your nonsense. You know, get the heck out of here. Get out of here with that lame-o. Let's see. Yeah, just, what, one damage? Yeah, that's what. Oh. Yep. That's why I did it. Also, because otherwise I'd be vine whipping you too. Alright, the wrap should finish. The wrap should finish him off. There you go.
Yeah!
I could have had. Oh, no, this is where I was before. Okay, so we're good. I could have had a mother loving Hoppip. Could have had a mother loving Hoppip. Sadness. Such unbelievable sadness. Instead, I get to look at this. Get to look at this little asshole. Just gonna just do this while drinking my soda. Getting one more. Yep. That's such a strange sound effect, but I like it. And you're done. My heart. Yep, okay. My heart, my soul. Could have had a Hoppip. It would have been dope. It would have been so... Nidoran, you can't do shit against me. You cannot do shit against me, Nidoran. Joey took down a Pidgey. He said, Joey can fuck dick. So what are you gonna do, Poison Sting? That you can't do shit. My childhood me was misplaced into thinking Nidoking was the coolest Pokemon. Okay, that was pretty I forgot you guys learned Peck. Except, I don't think- that was a critical hit, so I don't think you can kill me fast enough. Alright, we're switching out Budinge. We are switching out Budinge. 100%. Yeah. Good fight, little guy. Alright, let's switch Pokemon. Let's put, Mpritka in front. I don't have the most emotional attachment to Mpritka, but, I don't have anything that I have more emotional attachment with, so we're gonna work with him for now. Until we can come up with something new. There you go. Yeah. Slap the shit out of his foot. Just slap the shit. He has made a grievous error. But I don't remember. Oops. Okay. I don't remember, like, if... When does Beedrill learn that noise? Because I know I love it. I love it. And I can't have it. It's bullshit. Sire's happily skipping about. Yeah, cute button. I could have had a...
Dude.
That's a really good move. Bullet Seed. All things considered. Break my heart. Break my heart, mate. Well, okay, it's a really good move if we can find someone with Skill Link. Because Skill Link makes it so that multi-hit moves always fire their maximum amount of shots. And you can get away with some bullshit with that. And I think... Who gets Skill Link? It's, I know Cloyster does. Okay, we're switching out my prick up. But, I know Cloyster and Shellder get it. I think, Mega Heracross? I think Mega Heracross gets this. Well, there's a few others. But, yeah, bullet seed with that mess is sick. Sorry, I don't know if I've said this yet, but I have a weird knowledge of Pokemon. I'm not gonna pretend I'm perfect, but I'd be lying if I said that in high school I didn't read the Bulbapedia articles on most Pokemon. And even like nowadays, like when Gen 8 or whatever. We're in Gen 8 now? 7? 8? I forget. Whatever the new gen is, I will gut you, sir. I will gut you. Yes! I know you kept calling electric types lightning types. It's the same. It's the same thing. Okay, God. Wait, how are you picking up points? Yes. As Ethan said before, I'm gonna go give Kurt nuts. I'm gonna give him his nut. I'm gonna give him nuts. Alright, I wanna Google something real quick, and this is, once again, this is a little bit cheating, but this is from my knowledge. Old Rod. Cause correct me if I'm wrong, doesn't an old rod pretty much only get you Magikarp? Okay, it doesn't actually directly say on the wiki. Dang it.
It's the same, damn it, Mac, it's the same freaking thing, you know it. Don't give me this bullshit that lightning electric or dip, it's the same freaking thing.
Let's see. For a second I thought you said thought badge. Just like, thought badge, you have it! I was gonna be like, oh shit. Alright, you made a mistake in picking a fight with, oh god. This is how the gym fight could have gone, right here. Oh no. Oh, this could actually be bad. But, yeah, him, you, yep, this might be where the hurt comes. I will sit here and I will keep throwing rocks. They really make a big mistake. Yeah, they did. But, what was I saying earlier? I don't think you learn Drill Rush until much later, so screw you. But yeah, I have a weird knowledge when it comes to Pokemon, and I'm not gonna pretend I know everything. But it's a lot of stuff that I will sit here and be like, yeah, you learned this move at this time, and this guy's got this ability, and what is this person? Oh, he's a mixed attacker, you know, like, I'll just start pulling out weird shit like that just because it's what I do. Let's see. I know what my weaknesses are. It's a little rock with arms just beating the shit out of me when I'm not looking. That's my weakness. Aw, it's cute. He actually does it when he's outside. That's adorable. Shellbell? Oh my goodness, Shellbell! Is that the one that makes you friendlier? Wait, hold on. The hold his HP is restored a little every time it inflicts damage. Oh. Putting that on Wookden. So, I'm pretty sure Shellbell clicks off, or however you want to say it. I'm pretty sure Shellbell clicks off every time. Union Cave. Oh. Sex joke. Alright, Union. I can't spell Union Cave. There we go. But, I'm pretty sure Shellbell goes off every time you use, like, Fury Swipes or that kind of shit. So, no worries, Mac. Do what you gotta do. Ha ha, fuck you, Zubat. Fuck. You Zubat, here you go. Oh, you're a bastard. But yeah, I'm gonna do more damage to myself than you could ever do to me. Yeah, here you go, just take this. What was I saying though? Yeah, just weird knowledge. Cause it, like I said before, it wasn't until 7th grade where I first played Pokemon, and that was Crystal. And that was on an emulator. It was not the real deal. I didn't get the real deal until I got 3DS, which was not this one, but another one that my sister uses. I'm gonna just take this rock smash. There you go. Just gonna shkadoo shkadoo. So, also, I will not pretend for a moment that I'm, like, knowledgeable on the metas. Like, I'm not knowledgeable when it comes to, oh, these are the best strats to use with blah, 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 oh, baton pass and this cheesy ability, you know, like, that kind of stuff I have no knowledge on whatsoever. I will not pretend to have knowledge on it for a moment. There's probably metas and stuff that I'm just completely unaware of, and that's okay. I don't really care about metas. I just like playing and having fun. This guy scares me. I don't like him. I want an adult. I love Vulpix, though. But I want an adult. I want, where's my adult? Just take this rock. Just I'm gonna this beautiful little angelic oni pops out, and Chide just grabs a rock and just whips it at him. Like that lights up this cave. Well, thank you. I still don't like you though. And there's nothing in this Union Cave, is there? Cause I already got Rattata. I already got a Geodude. I already got a Zubat. Oh no, that was... Let me show you a tackle. Let me show you how it's really done. There you go. Let's see. Yep, there you go. Let's see. Yeah, thanks for lining up the cave. You're still creepy as I'll get out. Wear a shirt. Alright, there might be something new here. Just on the grounds of... it being a new floor. I mean... Dude, Rock Tomb's sick. Yeah, I think there's something special over there when you get Surf, but we don't have Surf right now. Butter off, Zubat. Butter off. Here, catch. Here, just hold on to this. Hold on to this. Just take this. Hold it in your chest, okay? Just hold it. Hold it right there. Just, you little bastard. Just take this. Just take this. Hold it in your chest. Right there. Just wrap your arms around this. There you go. It's okay now. Oh. Oh my goodness. Is there anything else in this cave with these three? God, I hope so. God, I would love a Dunsparce. I don't even know what I'd do with it. I don't even know what Dunsparces do. They're like, yeah, they're just one of the weird oddities that they're not even like... Yes, we're gonna move. If I keep Defense Curl, I can get Roll Out and make it super strong. So I'm gonna go get rid of Tackle. If I get takedown and double edge, I can get rid of tackle. Not worried about it. Yeah. Magnitude is a little bit of a gambling move, but it's the first real ground type move I got, so I'm gonna take it. Like, let's just okay. I was gonna say like let this be a Geodude. Let me show off the goodness that comes with. It comes with magnitude. So I am honestly sitting here and trying to think like eight steps ahead of like what Pokemon do I want or what I even want to use, but really I don't know what I'm gonna get, so shouldn't worry about it. Oh, hello Agent Maximus. It's good to have you here. Oh. Yeah, I'm trying to think like way ahead of like what Pokemon do I even want or like what strategies could I? Oh. You think you're hot shit? That could be bad. Magnitude 6. You're done. Oh, you lived? No. Dratini. Well, that's far future. Dratini would be kind of cool, though. But that's far future. I forget what. Who's the pseudo legendary in Gen 2? Is it Tyranitar? No, Tyranitar is later, right? Who's the pseudo legendary in this game? I don't remember. I think Ethan brought up Tyranitar earlier. So it might be that. I don't remember. I'm gonna keep tapping the screen. It keeps making it flash. Set Minch. Ah, jeez. I'm gonna keep spinning this. Ah, this is... Ah, no! No, I'm gonna feel bad. Oh, no. These guys... Wait, no, they don't learn... I was gonna say, they don't learn self-destruct until later. Whew. That'd be bad. Alright, meh. Yeah, I don't know if I want Chidane. I know a big point of a Nuzlocke is you get what you can take. Like, you take what you can get and you run with it kind of a thing. But I'm trying to think, like, who am I looking at and I'm like, this is the Pokemon that I genuinely want. As opposed to, these are the Pokemon I'm forced to use at this time. So that's why I'm like, I'm not 100% about Geodude. You know, like, I think he'd be good, but I'm not, like, jazzed, you know what I mean? Let's see, my team was Typhlosion, Tyranitar, Rhydon, Dragonite, Gyarados, Raikou. Oh, Raikou? Ah, you use legendaries, right? Unless you meant Raichu. Ah, I'm gonna have to give you grief, Agent Maximus. Big old cheater pants using legendaries. That's a me thing. I don't like using legendaries. It feels cheating. Or at least it does to me, like personally. Oh yeah, I forgot all the dogs are in this one. Oh god, I'm gonna have to fight the dogs, aren't I? I should add that to my contingency rules that if one of the legendaries pops up, they don't count for, they don't count as one Pokemon or out, kind of a thing. Chidane's starting to get kind of beat up. Like, he's still champing through, but, oh, yes. Not bad. Take what I can get. I'm fine. Still not getting anything beyond... Alright, hold on. Okay, how about this? I will Google, if I don't get a Pokemon in a route, I will Google what Pokemon are in that route after we leave it. Hello again, Mac. I won't Google what's on this route until I've finished it. So that way, if it's like... And the reason I say that is because as I will... That's impressive. Your poison might work through my rock a little bit. That's not good. And you levitate, so I can't use magnitude on you. But, because the last thing I'd want to do is I wouldn't want to walk into a route and be like, oh, the grass group number 3 has this Pokemon, so I'm going to go for this one. It's like, no, we'll take whatever we can get. And then if it's just for whatever reason we don't get anything, then we'll like turn back and be like, what Pokemon... You can tough through this fight. I'm beginning to think you can't tough it through this fight. Also, I'm sorry to hear that, Mac. Like, not sleep well? Or, like, if I may inquire. I can't really tell you to do anything beyond, like, the simple stuff, you know, like, eat an orange and stuff like that. Granted, I'm just a big supporter of oranges in general. Alright, yeah, we'll leave with Mupritka, but if we go up against any rock types, Mupritka's out. Oh wait, there's that path, top whatever. You need to investigate that. Yeah, as long as we're dealing with, like, small things like this Rattata, Mupritka will do just fine. As I spin my little... That for no reason is making my stomach hurt. Yeah, definitely. Know that, definitely. There you go. What can I say to help with that? Or what can I recommend to do? Therapy. remembering that no one in life expects you to be perfect. And if someone does expect you to be perfect, they're assholes. Remembering to always to treat yourself like someone you really like. Sorry, I'm going through the therapy things in my head for anxiety. Which obviously doesn't work for everyone. So let that be a full disclosure. I am not a therapist. I have been trained to be a counselor at like a Bible camp. But that's about it. So yeah, don't trust anything I say as gospel. Yeah, Chidan, you're fine. Freaking Chidan's a champ. Do you hear that music? Oh, what the fuck? Oh, God. My baby. My baby. I want one. I want it. It's gonna be my mascot. Give it to me. Oh, I just realized. Do you learn confusion yet? You're a bastard. I'm switching out. I'm gonna switch out to Budinge. Actually, no, I'm gonna switch out to Woodkin because I'm gonna make a bet that you either know Confusion or Water Gun. Nothing, like I said, there isn't a reason to, so I just got. Sorry to hear that. Which makes you feel disingenuous. That's not what I'm trying to do. I'm gonna sit here and just slash the shit out of you. That's what I'm gonna do. Yeah! Shoop. There you go.
Yeah! Yeah!
Larry, give me your fucking... Actually, no, don't give me your fucking Slowpoke. I'm gonna get my own fucking Slowpoke. Kill the Slowpoke. Kill also the future one that you can catch. Kill it. Ow! That thing is gonna be...
tight.
That thing is gonna be my baby, okay? I'm gonna have a Slowpoke, and it's gonna be my favorite. And I'm not gonna turn it into a slow king because slow kings are lame. I'm gonna turn it into a slow bro because they're fucking adorable and I love them. What if for the series I should like get a plush of a slow bro or something? That'd be kind of funny. Also, speaking of Slowpoke and Slowbro, I would not mind. I bet there's something in there. Nope, I was wrong. I would not mind a freaking Shellder or a Cloyster. That would be tight if I got a Cloyster or a Shellder. I'm just gonna run from this. Not even gonna worry about it. Like, those guys are just Geodude, I swear to goodness.
Hey man, I'm not the Geodude. Don't say that to me.
Like, fuck you, here we go. I'm gonna beat the shit out of you. But, yeah, just like super powered physical walls. Well, I don't know if they learn Icicle Spear yet. Yeah, get one with Skill Link and then Icicle Spear, Horn Attack. I think they can learn Twin Needle, Spike Cannon. Oh, there's something. Burp, sorry. There's something over there. I don't know what it is. I will be amazed if there is not something over there. Gonna run through and just kick the shit out of everything I can find. Leave a trail of bodies. Should be enough. There we go. God, cannot wait until Mapritka gets like poison jab or like some actually good like physical poison type move. Supposed to poison sting. Alright. Speaking of though, if the guy right before this cave was like, hey, wanna buy a Slowpoke tail, that means I'm gonna be reaching the Slowpoke well soon, which means we gotta come up with a name for our mascot. For our big boy. Wow, there's nothing here. What a rip-off. We gotta come up with a nickname for our big boy mascot who's gonna carry us all the way through this whole game. He's gonna carry the team. It's gonna be just Slowpoke. Yeah, so I'll go back to the winter. I can't help but giggle at that because my girlfriend is the exact opposite. That she's like the moment. Well, okay, so not to expound on her life to horse the soap. Nope, horse has got to be for someone else. Because horse is your mascot. I need my mascot. But she basically did some missions work in Thailand for 9 months. Route 33 is a new route. Route 33. But let's Google Union Cave. Let's Google it because we didn't find anything. Union Cave. But if I could say words, what am I trying to say? She was the exact opposite because like the moment it was it's hot, she's like, oh, thank goodness, I'm so, like, this is so much happier and nicer. But then, whatchamacallit? But then coming back to South Dakota, she's just like, oh, God, I want to die. All right, so, let me pull up the desktop. Let me pull up the desktop so you guys can see what I'm seeing. Let's also switch out that Zerg with the normal gone. Although I do love the Zerg. Zerg are my favorite. All right, so looking at this for SoulSilver, oh, we could have gotten Sand. I would have thrown Chidane so far off a cliff for Sandshrew. Sandshrew is fucking adorable. I could have gotten an Onix, which really I have Chidane, so who cares? Surfing, get a Wooper. Kind of cool. Let's see. Old Rod. It'd either be Magikarp or Golding. I wouldn't mind a Golding. Golding would be cool. But it would be, because they're both Gen 1, I would have to make that decision of, do I accept the Magikarp? And I know I'm getting the, I know I'm going to get the Red Gyarados later. I plan on killing it, to be honest. You're going to try to get those? The Goldings are great. Like, hang on, let me pull them up. More of the same. Let's just see. If you get lower in the cave, it's more of the same. I get a Tentacool. Krabby. Oh, God, I would love a Krabby. Krabby's are Staryu. Staryu would be pretty tight, too. Corsola. Corsola's pretty cool. Once per week, Lapras. Absol. I would be down for an Absol. Let's just see. Bronzor and Chingling. Not so much Chingling, but Bronzor I'd be down for. Yeah, Goldings are sick. They got, I think Water Veil is like they heal when it rains or something like that. Oh, prevents Pokemon from being burned. Not bad. Oh, the Sandshrew. Sandshrews are great. Yeah, see, they're physical fast walls. They learn Mega Horn. Well, I guess we're in Gen 4. They learn Mega Horn. And Peck. Peck is so good on a... Peck is so unbelievably good on a water type. Just to be like, oh, you want to use grass? You think you're hot shit? Fuck you. I claim. Yeah, if I remember correctly, sand shoes are just like real solid physical walls, right? Like, I know they get like good ground type moves. I think they get the defense curl rollout combo. But, what else? What else do they get? Let's see. I think they get Fury Cutter. They might get a few of the Fang moves, but I could be wrong about that. Shit, it's a Geodude. Mapritka. Fucking book it. And it's raining. Interesting. Alright, I'll switch in Mother Lovin'. But Dinge. I almost switched in Chidane on accent. That would have been bad. Now the switch in, but Dinge. Keep it simple. You spin your ass up. Go for it. I remember in, yeah, the one Sun and Moon Nuzlocke that I failed right at the end, I had an Alolan Sandshrew. The one that turns into, I want to say, Ice and Steel. That was badass. I love their designs. They're, once again, they're just so freaking cute.
Yeah!
When do I get to be Weeping Bell? Let me be Weeping Bell. Sharp. No, good luck. I think I have my stomach turned to it. Hey, Mac, it's okay. Don't worry about it. Definitely take care of yourself. That is the important thing. Get some rest. Oranges. If you can get access to oranges, that'll be super good. Yeah, no worries whatsoever. I'm thinking I might be streaming tomorrow. If not, you know, Facebook, Twitter, all that stuff, don't worry about it. You take care of you. That's the important thing. Don't put yourself out. Sure. Oh, sick, we're in Azalea. But yeah, 100%, take care of yourself first. That is the important thing. Oh, Azalea Town. Oh my gosh, it's a Slowpoke well. Let's kick the shit out of Team Rocket guy. They're coming back to pursue. Thud. You beat the shit out of an old man. I will deck you. Am I not a good Samaritan? Ah! Slowpoke well. I want to have the Slowpoke well. Don't worry, Azalea Town. I will fucking avenge you. Do just that. Let me guess, you're blocking the... Aren't you glad I told you that? Bugsy. Oh, sick. So... Oh, four fetches! Oh, that's right, we learned cut here, don't we? Which is ironic. Let's see. Which is ironic because the far fetches will cut the tail from the... he should be able to take care of it. Yeah, but I'm gonna make it possible to get through. The charcoal man's can cut down trees. Oops, I did not mean to do that. Excuse me, thank you. Give me. Shake the shit out of it. Alright, just bloop. There we go. Oh, Joey! Joey, what do you want? How? Anyway. Thank you. Thank you for informing me of this. I should not. Like, okay, I know. I like. Oh. Oh, there you go. I'd like to remind everyone, this is a kid's game for children. And each game is designed so that you could have zero experience in Pokemon and play it and have fun. Okay? So I want everyone to know I acknowledge this as an adult. I am an adult. I am a grown-ass man. I am 25 years old. Hello, child. Thank you. Let's see. Oh, the bear. I'm supposed to see in shop. Sick. Yeah, if... Netballs. I love how net and dusk balls look when you throw a Pokemon out. But, Ooh, I got money. I got a lot of money. Sick. All right, let's buy like a handful of these. Yes, I'd like to remind everyone, I'm a grown-ass adult. I have served in the military, the U.S. Navy, for 4 years. On a darker note, went through a marriage. It did not go well. Like, I am an adult. I recognize this is a children's game for small children. That being said, I'm a big believer in that. I think it was something that, was it Tolkien? Tolkien said it? That, like, something that, you know a book is good when, you know, like, a children's book is good when a you know, when an adult can enjoy it just as much, if not more so, than a child. Kind of a thing. You know, yeah, a show should, like, a book that is for children should also be interesting to adults. Not necessarily in that every book needs to be about, like, wildly, whatchamacallit, moral philosophies and beliefs and stuff, but in the sense of... Don't mess this up for me. But in the sense of it should still be engaging and interesting. I'm not getting any cans, okay? I'm not fucking getting any cans. Burp, I'm not gonna do it. No, no, Gen 1 claws. Gen 1 claws, bitch. I'm not getting any cans. Unless we, like, kill 3 or 4 Pokemon and I'm getting nothing new, and then I will begin to consider any cans. And even then, I don't want any cans. At all. I've played entire games with Ekanses before, just like I've played entire games with Zubats before. I don't want to do it. Yes, I will sit here and I'll be butthurt about this. Oh, as a fun challenge, if you want to play a Pokemon game sometime, but, like, you want to make it more interesting, but you don't necessarily want to do a Nuzlocke kind of a thing, I would highly recommend doing a playthrough with only bug Pokemon, or doing a playthrough only... Fucking taking it. I want it. I want it. I want it. I want it. It's mine. It's so cute. I want it. Yep, we're gonna hop it. I'm throwing Budinge away. I want it. I think Budinge will actually do the least amount of damage to it. If I use Wrap, it will keep doing damage that might kill it. It's so cute. Oh my goodness, it's so cute. I want it. Let's just do a cursory test. I might be able to lure. Oh, no, well, fish, no, no, just. But, yeah, use only bugs or use only the Pokemon that Team Rocket and dumb people use. Both of which I think are, like, pretty fun challenges. They kind of, like, they make you think a bit more about what you're gonna need to do. So for, like, Gen 1 and 2, it would be, like, for Gen 1 and 2, you know, like, it would be Pokemon like Meowth, Zubat, Koffing, Ekans, Muk, well, Muk and Grimer. Some of them use Machop and Drowsy kind of thing. So there are those, like, little exception ones, but it's a good time. And then, for bugs here, well, in Crystal, what I use, I had a Beedrill and Butterfree, obviously, but I also had, like, I got a Heracross and a Scyther, I think. I could be wrong about that. Venonat. Venonat was solid on my team. But just, yeah, it's fun change of pace. Yes. Alright, everyone in chat, help me out with the nickname. Because I will make up something until you guys, unless you guys have another suggestion. And I'm going to Google in different languages. Alright, I'm going to show you guys how I name characters in D&D. Alright. Buckwheat. Well, no, hold on. It's a cottonweed Pokemon, right? So, let's put in the word Fluffy. Yeah. Yeah, this is what I do until you guys come, unless you guys can think of something better. I don't say that as a threat. I mean that as just like a, like, I'll usually take your guys' suggestions into account, but this is what I do when left to my own devices. Bali? Balihas? I kind of like that. Balihas? Balio? Balio. Balio. Balio, congratulations. Your name is gonna be... Oops. Bosho. And you best believe I'm replacing Buttinge's ass with yours. Heck yeah to Bolhyo. Also, let's be honest. It's gonna be a Magikarp. Let's just get out of the way and be honest with ourselves. It's gonna be a Magikarp. Which is why I'm gonna do it. Damn it. Alright, what do we got? Yeah, whatever. Yeah, it's gonna be a Magikarp, but I'm gunning essentially for that 15% chance that it won't be a Magikarp. And then also, I keep saying as Ethan said, because he was here on the last time we streamed this game. As Ethan said, I catch the one Zubat to guarantee that I never have to catch another Zubat. And if I get a Magikarp here, will I be frustrated? Yes, but also, you know, that we got it. So I'll never have to sit there and be like, oh no. Register it. What does that mean, register it? Oh, sick! Damn. But, you know, we get it now, so we don't have to get it. Yep. It's level 10. You know, it's nice. Magikarp. I don't want to kill it, and I want to say Magikarp is one of those Pokemon that, like... Yeah, I want to say Magikarp is just one of those Pokemon that you can just catch it. Just throw, done. Kind of thing. Ah, come on. Can't believe I'm being insulted by a Magikarp. I can't believe it. Oh my gosh, I'm going to have to hit it. I'm going to have to hit it. Who has the guaranteed weakest move? Because all I can think of is Sudasnoot and Ember. Oh my goodness. I'm gonna waste a lure ball on you. I'm gonna waste a freaking lure ball on you. Yep, that's what I'm doing with my life. Motherfucker. Fine, you're getting poison stung. And if you die, frankly, it's your fault. Just frankly, you deserve this. Okay, so that's how much damage it does. So this time, I'm not gonna risk the critical. It's gonna get one more. Now, Magikarp, we understand that you have loyalty to the American government. We would respect. Oh, I just realized I forgot to change it to this mod. My bad. We understand you have loyalty to American government. I understand. You know, being loyal to one's own home country. Splash. Let's see. For no reason, it jumps and splashes about, making it easier for predators like Pidgeotto to catch it mid-jump. It's a 2-foot-tall 11 fish. We understand that you have loyalty, but if you do not sprut, but if you do not join us, stank, if you do not join us, there will be consequences, Spruzzo. I kind of like Stroppy and, Tilka? Silipka? I kind of like Stroppy. Yep, all right, we're gonna name it Stroppy. Yep, switch back to this. Alright, your name is gonna be I recognize this isn't how it was spelled. That's part of the joke. Cause you know, I want it to be a reference to another language, but I don't want it to be too easy. Joey, I swear to goodness. Thank you. Joey. This is why I don't use Twitter. This is why. This is why, Joey. Joey, you're a piece of shit. Just get progressively more aggressive. Man, screw you, man. I'm gonna kick your ass in a second. Alright, let's heal everyone up and let's switch around our team a little bit. Yes, I would like to rest my Pokemon. Alright, so looking at my team, I'm gonna want to switch out Bellsprout for Hoppip in full recognition that Hoppip probably does not have a good grass type move to its name. In full recognition, okay? I want everyone to know that I know that. Bullet Seed, I might... If I can put Bullet Seed on Hoppip, that'd be pretty sick, honestly. Alright, move Pokemon. Okay, so we got on standby, as you can see, at the very top. We got Skrikey, Squeakus, Bulhyo, which I need to write down. Bulhyo. And Magikarp. Name's Stroppy. Yep, okay. So, versus our team, we have Beedrill, we have Mipritka, Chidane, Budinj, Sudasnoot, and Wookden. I'm going to get rid of Budinj solely on the grounds. There we go. Of it is a Gen 1 Pokemon, so I already know what it does. For those of you who don't know, let's just grab this. Bag? Yes. For those of you who don't know, it turns into a Weeping Bell pretty soon, and it learns a bunch of Spore moves. Not Spore itself, but like Poison Powder, Sleep Powder, and stuff like that. It learns a Swallow, Spit Up, and Stockpile moves, and it turns into a Victory Bell with Mother Lovin', whatchamacallit, Grass Stone. Bulhyo learns it. All right, I'm gonna cheat just a little bit, okay? I'm gonna cheat just a little bit. Okay, because I'm gonna be looking up Hoppip anyway. Does Hoppip learn a genuine grass move? Let's see. NA. Oh, this is Gen 4. Or Gen 7 is Gen 4. All right, it does not learn. Wow, it will not learn. Yeah, Splash, Synthesis, Tail Whip, Tackle at level 10, Poison Powder, Stun Powder, Sleep Powder, that's 12, 14, 16, and Bullet Seed at level 19. It does not start learning aggressive moves until then. And it turns into Skip Bloom at level 18, so really that 19 is irrelevant. Skip Bloom doesn't, let's see, when does Skip Bloom learn moves? Not until level 20. Yeah, so I'm gonna give Hoppip freaking Bullet Seed because otherwise it will literally not be able to fight. Like, period. It will not be able to fight. Alright, so you are gonna be removed. I'm gonna grab this. Make him nice and big. There you go, right there. You little cutie patootie. Look at you. So freaking cute. I love you. Alright, let's minimize all this. Rock Tomb would be really useful. Oops, yep, okay, cool. And, yes, I would love to teach Bullet Seed to a Pokemon. To Bulhyo. Fuck yeah. Alright, I just want to see. Who here can learn Rock Tomb? Chidane. Chidane's already got Rock Throw, and later on he's gonna get, like, Stone Edge and shit. So, really, I'm not worried about him with that. Mipritka is able to learn Roost, which would be interesting, but I don't think worthwhile. You know what I mean? Because Roost's whole thing is that it heals you for 50%, but it, what was it? It heals you for 50%, but you lose your flying typing, and most birds can learn it. Oh, he's so cute. He's so cute. Oh my goodness. So it's kind of interesting because you can use it to heal, but you can also use it if you're like a Pidgey or whatever. And you can, let's see. I've recorded nothing else, so stubborn Pokeball creator. Except, oh yeah, that's right. You haven't talked to him. But, what am I trying to say? It's cool because it gives you the ability to heal. And, like, even after you lose your flying typing, you could still use it. But, yes, it makes it so you don't have stab on flying type moves. But it also makes it so you're not weak to flying type weaknesses. So, like, if someone's hitting you with lightning attacks, you can just remove that weakness. But also makes it so you can be hit by things like earthquakes. So, there's a lot of back and forth. You know what I mean? Let's see. For sale. Sick. We're gonna get a Slowpoke. The moment Grandpa leaves, just like, the moment Grandpa leaves, like, she's gone, I'm so lonely. Will you be my grandpa? And I'm like, oh shit. can I ain't your dad. I ain't your grandpa. I'm gonna go catch a bug. I'm gonna see about catching a bug. I was gonna say, don't mess with me, Grandma. Stay out of mischief.
Hey, it's the thing I have as my background here! Hey! Hey!
Ilix Forest. Dude, let's see if we can get a sicko bug. Hopefully. Oh yeah, that's right. Isn't this a? That's not a Moss Rock. Oh, Jesus, a cave. What do I get? It's so cute. I love it. Do I want to invoke the rule? Yes, I want to invoke the rule. Yes, I'm not saying that just because it's Paris, but yes, I would like to invoke the rule. So I'm gonna switch to someone who I am not afraid of dying, who is Paprika. Because, okay, so I've used Paris's before. Paris is another. Motherfucker, think you're hot shit, don't you? Have a poison sting. Oh, you're already paralyzed, you little piece of shit. There you go, have that. There you go, bleh, super effective. But, yeah, screw you. Too late. But I've used Paris's before, and they're another Pokemon that's like low-key. Paris and Parasect, I really like them both. But they're not good. They are not good at all. And I mean that genuinely. Like, Poison Grass is a cool. Took me. Alright. Let me just Google in different languages for the word. Yes, I would love to. Yes. I will name it Omelette. Omelette du Mofrage, or whatever the bit is from Dexter's. In Italian. Let's see. Omelette tortilla. I like it. Tortilla. Yep, your name is Tortilla. Congratulations. Like mine. I'm not a tortilla. You are oops. Your name is yes, I am spelling it wrong on purpose. Your name is Tortilla. You are my little Spanish friend. Oh my goodness, Professor, I'm falling in a ditch.
You better not have named that Pokemon something stupid. You should come here and check me out. Nope.
But, that's not possible. What am I saying? I should look at what Tortilla's got for moves. Yeah, Parasite, this is not very good, to be 100% honest. Let's see. Growl extra sensory? Alright, objectively, extra sensory is a really fucking good move. Sure, it's a little weaker than psychic, but it makes him flinch. That's a really good move. Like, holy shit. That is... if... whew. You know, I wasn't thinking about using Tortilla. But now I am. Tortilla is secretly kind of a baller with extra sensory. Having just a straight up psychic type on our team. Just, jeez. But, Parasys. So, like I said, their grass bug typing is interesting and cool. But that makes them 4 times weak to flying and 4 times weak to fire. It gives them so many more weaknesses than it gives them for benefits, kind of a thing.
Yeah, you're a little speedster. Hey! You're making progress, little guy. I love you.
But, what am I saying? Yeah, it gives them... we already have Paprika. I think you're gonna use Poison Sting, so I'm gonna switch out. Because that will kill my little dude. There you go. But, oops, I did not mean to do that. I'm going to think Harden is the only move you know. But, what was I going to say? Yeah, I'm beginning to think I could have just, used, you know... Could have sent in my little dude. I was just going to switch that. But, yeah, it gives them so many more weaknesses than it gives them for positive traits. And they're designed to be a physical wall. And they're slow as shit. And they don't have that much health. And they don't have that much attack. And they don't have that much defense. And they learn a lot of special moves. And they have very low stats there, too. And they're super weak to special attack moves. And they get Effect Spore, which makes it so that moves under a certain power are boosted in power. Or, no, that's Technician. Effect Spores, if something touches them, there's a chance that they'll be affected by a random spore. And I want to say the choices are, like, poison. Yeah, I want to say the choices are, like, poison, stun, or sleep. All of which are really cool. You will straight up kill Bolio. Like, Bolio will die if I leave you in there, kind of a deal. So I'm just gonna do everyone a favor and just kind of switch you out, yeah. Yeah, you can't poison me, bitch. Yeah. Oh, they were the original team that could learn Spore, which is a really nice move. And I think, I kind of think the reason Parasys and Parasect are so weak is because of Spore. And, like, their myriad of status moves, because Spore makes it so that you guarantee go to sleep. It is 100% accurate. You will go to sleep. And it's scary, kind of a deal. That, like, and I'm sure a lot of people gonna look up Ilex Forest while we're fighting. I'm sure a lot of people are like, oh, you know, use, there we go, get a Parasect to be super duper fast and then have it use Spore and then it'll make everything fall asleep, and isn't that hilarious? And yeah, I know, but it's not really my dig. It's not how I like to play. Alright, let's see, Fury Attack. Okay, so according to Bulbapedia, in Gen 4, we are playing in the afternoon. In SoulSilver, there is just Weedle, Kakuna, Zubat, and Paris. But at nighttime, there are Oddishes. If you headbutt, there is a chance you can get a Hoothoot. There are special trees that you can headbutt. There's a chance you can get a Pinako, which strikes me as so much cooler. There's fishing later where you can get a Poliwag. Special Pokemon. Whatever. So really... okay, we'll catch a Paris next time we're in here, because there's literally nothing else to get. You know what I mean? So this is when the Gen 1 clause kind of like falls out. In this game in particular. Because there's so much Gen 1 Pokemon. That I'm just like, you know, fucking whatever. I'll take the Paris. I don't plan on using it. Like, ever. I've used a Paris before in my bug only run. Parasect was one of the guys on my team. He was my anti-water. And he did okay, basically. It was great when he learned X Scissor. Jeez, when he learned X Scissor, it was amazing. But even then, that was basically it. It was always just okay. But anyways, I'm gonna go to the bathroom really quick because I really gotta pee. So I'm gonna be right back. Give me just a second. Thank you for waiting. And let me just get situated in my chair. All right, oh, that's right, Ilex Forest. Yeah, so next time we go in there, we'll just catch a Paris, just because there's basically nothing else in there. Oh, that's right, we also gotta get rid of, we got a certain Pokemon to dump off at the daycare, because don't get me wrong, I am tempted to just abuse that shit. Hustle. Is Hustle the one that, like, you get stronger if you're, what does Hustle do? Hustle increases the user attack by 50%, but it lowers the accuracy of the user's physical moves by 20%. Special moves and status moves aren't affected by Hustle. I forgot about Hustle. I completely forgot about Hustle. That was another big strategy with Togekiss's. And I want to say, and I just grabbed its moves. Growl, Charm, Metronome, Sweet Kiss, Yawn, Encore, Follow Me, Wish. He doesn't get a directly attacking move that stays consistent to level 33. Yeah. Togepi is weird. Simple as that. Togepi is weird. Let's see, fourth gen. What about Togetic? Magical Leaf if you get a mover learner, but same deal. Yeah, I am not for the Togepi. Let's refresh chat real quick. I'm not for Togepi at all. So I'm gonna deposit your ass. Yep, get rid of it. Yep, don't care. Don't care. Oh, let me write down egg Togepi tortilla, I named it. Yep, alright, cool. So now we can continue forward. But thoughts. I don't know. I have a really bad habit of just like rambling at high amounts of speed. because, to be honest, a big part of this channel is just me having that space to have an open consciousness kind of a deal, yeah? Here we go. Time to get my boy. Slow poke. Well, first thing I get is a Zubat. Took time out of the well, I slammed it out hard on my back so I can't move. If I fit my Pokemon to punish them, I can't be helped. Next time I get you in my place. You got it. Look at this reflection. That looks really nice. Here we go. Ow. We can't make it! Nope. This is gonna be bad. And some old coot yelled at me, so I thought, how about I vent my and take it on you? Oh, jeez. Oh, jeez, my first Team Rocket battle! Bolio, you got this! And Bolio's like, what? Oh, I forgot to remove it over here. Level 9? Yeah, Bolio, you ain't gonna win. Straight up, no, this is not your fight. You are not gonna win. I'm gonna get the Pritka in there. Get him up to snuff. Obviously, we need to get Snoot in there as well, but he's gonna get up there just fine. It's a Quilava. Like, it's a freaking Quilava. It's gonna just ram its head through anything. I have no concern. I mean, it's a starter. Even in that sense, it's a starter. It's gonna live. Alright, so. Yeah. Yeah, Booyo! You're still pretty small. I'm not gonna risk it. I could try to switch him back in, but I got a feeling in my gut it would not end well. I mean, yeah, I know. Like, okay, so to Mapritka, he only does 4 points of damage, but to Polio, who has, like, no defense, it's not gonna end well. Yeah. Yeah, suck my nards. And selling them. Sure, we've been hacking the tails off Slowpoke and selling them. What about it? What are you gonna do about it? My babies. See, what? You want us to disobey a direct order from Executive Proton? Executive Proton. No, we don't have a theme. Yeah, I'm wearing short shorts. Yeah, they're kind of hot. What about it? Alright, level 9, so he's getting there, but he's not quite there. Let's get worked into there. I'm willing to make a bet as I pour myself some more soda that, that thing, maybe not. Maybe it doesn't learn Wing Attack or Bite yet. It will soon, though. Maybe it's in, like, the 10s somewhere. I'm gonna Fierce Swipe your ass. No! That lead. Well, no! Hoppip is part flying, so. Yeah. Probably would have been fine. Should have more faith in my, Well, actually, no, because Hoppip, the only damaging move it has is freaking Bullet Seed. That's times 4 weeks, so. So that's not gonna. That would not end well for it. See, I heal after every hit, right? What? What? Does Shell Bell not work for Mudderfoot? Do I risk it? Nah, let's not risk it. Unless I growled it first. Hey, I'm Googling this. Max is not above Googling shit. Shell Bell. Nope, Shell Bell has a space in it, Max. Mudder. Okay, if the holder uses a multi-strike move, it recovers HP after the last strike, considering the damage from all the strikes at once. What? Wait, hold on. Okay, whenever the Pokemon holding it deals damage to the move, it restores HP equal to 1/8 of the damage dealt. Rounded down, but not less than 1. Okay. Yeah, so in Gen 3, it recovers HP after each strike, considering damage from that strike only. But in Gen 4... Okay, so it is effectively the same. It does work effectively the same, even if... Yeah, okay. They grow back fast. It's like, oh, well, so it's totally fine then. Sick bastards. I'm giving myself a slowpoke. I will kick each and every one of your individual asses, except for the slowpokes, because they're my babies. I literally started this entire series just so I could have a slowpoke. That is a genuine fact. Is it time? Let's do it. Yeah, boy, yo, go, go, go. Yeah, beat the shit out of him. You got miracle. Oh, no. Oh, no. Oh, no. That's not very much. Oh, no. I bet I can do this. Come on, this is Bolio's moment to... We got... Bolio, this is your time to fucking shine. You are fast, you are strong, you are beautiful, you are a handsome young man. Just look at you. Look at you, you're just doing so good. Look at that lower defense ass Rattata. Dude, you're doing so good. Dude, see, you're doing beautiful. You're just so lovely. Look at you, just bam, done. You did that by yourself, little guy. Look at all the experience you're getting. Yeah. Yeah, look at all that experience. That was you. Shit. Actually, wait, this might be fine. I'm gonna tail whip you. I think this will be fine. Because flying should cancel out your lead. I'm just insist. That's right. I have a self-healing move. So unless you can magically kill me in one shot, please don't magically kill me in one shot. Yep, see, totally fine. Oh wait, hold on, bullet seed. Alright, it's like, oh wait, shit. Fuck it, we'll set him up for a But, I'm feeling... I'm feeling pretty confident in Bolio. I feel pretty confident in Bolio. Like, he's gonna get there before you know it. Also, I just realized, I think we have an all-boys team. This is us and the dudes. Yeah. Bet I can, Yeah, definitely, I'd say Bolio is not the level where I can in good faith switch him in. To, like, take a hit and then in good faith switch him out to make sure he gets the experience power level in a little bit. Nah, whatever. Unless, like, a lot of miracles happen, the Pritka's gonna be able to take this and give it back just as hard. Okay, now I'm not so sure. I shouldn't have done that. Down. Damn it. Nope. Nope. So they're just like... I bet I would have been fine. I will bet you just about anything. I would have been 100% fine. But just playing it safe. Sometimes I just playing it safe. All right. Bolio, go to level 10, see? Yes. Yes, forget a move. Forget splash, which is... hilarious that it has that as a move at all. Paprika! Dude, everyone's getting levels! Chidane's doing great! I don't know when it evolves into Graveler, but it'll be soon, I feel like. Let's look at our Pokemon. They're fine. Let's start getting a Pseudosnoot in there, because he's... Yeah, Chidane's getting a bit much. So we need Pseudosnoot and Wookden to get again there.
My baby. Yes.
Oh no. Oh,
my baby. I will kill you, you bitch.
And cruelest guy, Team Rocket.
Proton.
Fiak. Ah, shit. I only went away. They're like, ah, shit. This ain't gonna go well for me. All right, now we're switching Pseudosnoot. Nope. You hurt my babies, you bastard. And I don't have a name yet for... I don't have a name yet for Slowpoke. The first thing in my head is to call him Bagoo, and that doesn't sound right to me. Also, I think this is the first battle I've actually used Quilava. God damn it. No. I'm gonna light your ass up. Come on. Oh my goodness. Oh my goodness. Is this how... Is this how Pseudosnoot dies? Like, just, he's sitting there just killed. There you go. Like, quick, supersonic him again. I was genuinely hoping it would. I thought that'd be hilarious. Hilarious if I could not have my voice squeak. Oh, yeah. Bitch. Shkadoo shkadee. This is for thee. Oop. Yeah, bull yo. Yeah, Pseudosnoot. Show him what's up. Coughing. You're level 12? You're level 12, and also, I bet you know Smog, so I'm gonna play it safe. Poison Gas would have been bad, but I probably would have been fine, all things considered. Yep, that's what I was afraid of right there. But I think that move can also poison. Thinking you could mess with our plans, witch? Oh, you're down. All of that experience could have gone to Bolio. Could have gone to Bolio. But we continue our activities underground. Very afraid of ways to come. Yes, you know, poke babies. Oh, the big babies. Oh, you... No.
But what about my babies?
Yeah, I've come back with a bad feeling. In any case, so please be ready to make Pokeballs for a trainer. Like, Q-Max is all I have now, but take it. I think it's the one... Is that the one that, like, you just use it immediately? Yes. 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 Oh.
What? What? I forgot.
Oh my, I can only make one at a time. Oh, God. Oh. Oh, that's torturous.
Oh.
That hurts.
They're so fucking cute.
Oh, Joey. Oh. I have my nose. Good, you buggered off. Ah, sorry. Are you the cut man? Yeah, that's it. Where in the world is that lazy guy? Oh, yeah, so that's the next thing we gotta do. We gotta go to the forest and, like, chase that Farfetch'd around. I remember that. I'm a Slowpoke.
I'm gonna get me a Slowpoke.
Now for Slowpoke here, I need to come up with a genuine name. I can't just I can't just make something stupid up. This guy's my mascot. This guy's gonna carry me through the whole freaking game. It's gonna be me. It's gonna be me and Slowpoke. Like the whole game. I was gonna say, it was like, where's my Slowpoke? Motherfucker. Piece of shit. Get the fuck out of here. Just absolute. Actually, no, I'm gonna kill you. I'm gonna kill you because I can now. It'll take me a second. But I can actually kill you now. Personally. And you know what? If you hurt me too bad, I'm just gonna synthesis. So there. Yeah, let's Google while I'm doing this. Let's Google Bulbapedia Slowpoke. See if we can look at like name origins, see what its name is in different countries. Or maybe I could just come up with just a genuine name for it. Let's see. In Japanese, it is Yadon. French is Romulus. Spanish is Slowpoke. German is Phlegmon. Italian is Slowpoke. Korean is Yadon. Cantonese Chinese is Siu Daisu, but I'm probably pronouncing that wrong. Literally means little slow-witted creature. And in Mandarin Chinese, it's Dai Dai Shao, which means slow-witted creature. Hindi, it's Slowpoke. Russian, it's Slowpoke. Thai, it's Yadon. Transcription from the... Name origin is literally Slowpoke, a term counselor, slow and poke, an abbreviation of Pokemon. Yadon may be a combination of Yadokari, which is hermit crab, and Donkan, which is thick-headed or stolid. Whereas Don means slow, dull, or stupid. Alternatively, may also derive from Yadonushi, which is parasitic host based on its relationship with shelter and its evolutions. Let's just do that. Okay. Let's see. I swear to goodness, if there is not a Slowpoke in this cave, I will throw a fit. Yeah, Slowpoke well. Let's see. In... Oh, it's only... Wow, it is only a 15% chance. Well, ladies and gentlemen, we are here for the long haul until I can come up with an actual good name for this Slowpoke. Because my first instinct is to name him Bagoo, and that's not right. That's not noble enough. Noble, that's it. Famous lazy knights like Kniggets. Sir Kay. Seven lesser known knights of the round table. Okay, sorry, I have to actually look down now because my screen is taken. Let's see. In later literature he is known for his acid tongue and bully. Let's see. Sir Kay is known for his acid tongue and bullying boorish behavior, but I know he's one of Arthur's premier's worst. Along with Bedivere, whom he is frequently associated, Kay is one of the earliest characters associated with the character. It's called Ector in later literature, but the Welsh cast name him Sinir Sinfarkdukul. I don't know how to pronounce that. Ooh, seven Sir Lamorak. Let's see, Sir Gareth. A faithful and was known for his chivalrous nature. Let's see. Sir Agravain is one of the most handsome knights, but he was proud and arrogant. And ungentlemanly like conduct, we're not about that. Sir Geraint. One day, Geraint heard Enid complaining. Wait, hold on. The eldest son of King Urban of Demonia, Sir Geraint was a knight of Devonshire. After the death of his first wife, Geraint began spending a lot of his time at Arthur's court looking for action-adventure. During this time, he went on to meet Lady Enid of Caertheim of Cardiff and married her. Geraint and his wife Enid became... Nope, this is not a fucking... This is not a Slowpoke. Geraint and his wife Enid became good friends with both King Arthur and Queen Guinevere. Oh, he married her. One day, Geraint heard Enid complaining that he was a lazy knight. This upset him greatly, and he was determined to prove his manliness. Geraint then went on tour of Demonia with his wife and faced several trials and challenges. Let's just use synthesis. He triumphed eventually and showed his worth as a good leader and a skillful fighter. The journey managed to intensify the bond between the cup and also enhance Geraint's reputation among the other knights around the table. That is fucking beautiful. We are naming him Geraint. Geraint? Geraint? Let's look at the other ones. Let's see. So he was a chastened noble knight. He had to take a Valerian single throughout his life. Our current daughter is smitten with him. King Urien. I'm just going to keep using tackle. King Urien was the father. Nope. Sir Lionel. Let's see. Yeah, whatever. Okay. Sir Geraint. Let's name him Sir Geraint, son of Urban. I'm going to just grab him tackle. Let's see. So now let's Google Sir Geraint. This is what we do. This is the kind of research that we do. Let's see. It's not actually. Dang, I was hoping it would like say it out loud how to pronounce it in case I was doing it wrong, which I probably am. He was the king of Demonia, Valium. The name Geraint is a Welsh form of the Latin Geratonus, meaning old man. He is considered a saint with his wife Enid. Well, how about this? We'll see what gender it is, and if we can name it Enid if it's a girl, or we can name it Geraint if it's a boy. Am I pronouncing that right? Is it Geraint? How to pronounce Geraint? Hold on. How to pronounce Geraint is a YouTube video.
I thought I'd do a quick video around how to pronounce my name because people always ask me the right way to pronounce it.
Because it is a fairly unusual Welsh name. It dates back to the 7th century Greek derived.
Well, I've done it. The
guy said, do you mind if I call you Jerry? Sometimes I'm not in Gary. Okay.
Rhymed as in pint. And if you just keep practicing saying egg pint, egg pint, egg pint. Again and again, that sort of gets you in the mindset to say it properly. So thanks for tuning in. If you liked it, leave me a like.
What do you say?
In egg pint, Ger is in egg. So the right way to say Geraint, I think,
Geraint.
Is Ger is in egg.
Geraint. Oh, oops. I should probably say that. Geraint. I can do that. Geraint. 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 See, the more you learn on this show, we fucking learn things. Alright, God. But we're also betting for that 15% chance, which is not very good, but you know what? We're gonna do it. Geraint. Sir Geraint. Knight Geraint. Knight Geraint. I like it. It's a very noble name for a slow bro.
I like the idea, though, that as, like, an Arthurian legend that, like, one day he heard his wife complain that he's kind of lazy, and he turned around and said, "You fucking what?" And then just did amazing things. He's like, "Think I'm lazy. Look at me. I'm freaking cool shit." Alright, I'm gonna synthesis it up. Alright, Slowpoke Well. Slowpoke, I'm gonna put parentheses, mascot. And then I'm going to say Geraint. And I'm going to spell it exactly as it is spelled for Arthurian legend. Because that's what we do. But if I was going to spell it differently, Geraint. Grant. Grant. Now, I'm not going to call him Grant. I'm not going to call him Grant. Because, see, my sister and my parents got me into Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. And there's a character that, I'm not going to spoil what his deal is, but I hate his guts. And his name is Grant Ward. And if I called my Slowpoke Grant, I would cry. So, it's going to be great. We're just going to be killing a lot of Zubats in the meantime, so everyone, buckle up. You're here. For the long haul. Can I go over there? Okay. Come on. Ah, the confusion.
confusion can legit get me killed. Of course, like, the damage- oh, that's Cricklet. The damage he does to me and the damage I do to myself isn't very much. Okay, now I'm scared. Now I'm scared. Now I'm scared. Out, out, out. You're getting out, you're getting out, you're getting out. Believe in we're putting Pseudosnoot in. If anything, I should probably go heal. Because as long as we're going to sit here and grind in the desperate hopes of getting Slowpoke. Yeah, it's one of those things of like, as long as we're here anyway. There you go. Yeah, as long as we're here anyway, this is a great opportunity for Hoppip to grind. So we're gonna do it.
It's lovely, lovely little town. It's so lovely here.
We are going to, I guess while I also, while I'm grinding, because there is a lot of time that I'm just kind of sitting here doing nothing, I can get Slowpoke. Restore your Pokemon to full health. Yep, alright. Get down to the Slowpoke. Oh my goodness, Joey! What did I just do?
Joey.
Actually, I might. Nah, I'll take the one from HeartGold. That's what we've been doing. Alright, save the image. Get my butt back in there. Open this up. Slowpoke well. There you go. Okay. I don't even know if this is like the main location. I'm just gonna pretend it is. Get over here, grab that Slowpoke. Boo, boo, boo. Alright, we gotta rearrange everyone a little bit. Yeah, you gotta move over. You gotta move over, Quilava. You may be my starter, but you're not the mascot of this escapade. That's for Sir Geraint. Once we catch him, which I'd like to remind everyone of my claws of. Damn it, my claws that is straight up. I have the least amount of emotional attachment towards you, Beedrill. I'm gonna go home somehow. One, right there. Yep. This is order of current emotional attachment. Actually, no, hold on. Let's have it in order of like team. Whatchamacallit? Team practicality. There we go. Actually, this is honestly the team that we got right now. Is not a bad team. Like, okay, obviously we shouldn't say, like, this is a team I'm gonna play the rest of the game with. But, like, you know, we got our water psychic. We got our solid fire. We got a grass flying, which I don't know if it, I don't remember on the list if it said if it learns gust, but golly, I hope it does, because that'd be amazing. I might be thinking of a different Pokemon that's like Grass Fairy, but that thing learns Whirlwind. The one that's like based on a giant cotton ball. And not this one that's based on a cotton weed, the one that's based on a cotton ball. There's a distinct difference. But, yeah, there you go. So, yeah, we got our Water Psychic, we got a Fire, we got a Grass Flying, which is pretty cool. We got a solid Normal type kind of a deal. Geodude is a solid rock ground. Nothing wrong with that. And then Beedrill is our bug poison. You know, so kind of cool. If anything, though, the people who are most replaceable on the team totally is Beedrill and Ferret and Ferret, though. And that's me saying that, and I really like Ferret. But they actually, yeah, all three of the bomb ones are totally replaceable in terms of, like, team dynamics, what we could have. Like, if I got the Mareep, Beedrill would have been out. 100%. I would have thrown Beedrill to the curb. Because I want mine. Because I freaking lightning type would round this out so well. Having Togepi for the extrasensory is a fun idea, but Togepi doesn't do anything else except extrasensory. Like, I could sit there and try to do Charm and Growl and maybe Metronome, but I am playing the Metronome game. Metronome game is dumb. Like, it's a fun idea for a spell. It's a fun idea for a move, but in practicality, it's not good. It's miserable to just, like, you know, because one of the moves can be self-destruct. Or one of the moves could just be something that gets you in trouble, or, like, just fucks you up somehow, or maybe it's Curse, maybe it becomes Belly Drum, maybe it, you know, becomes moves that hurt you, and then you're just like, well, I'm dead. It's like, yeah, you're dead because you're dumb. Oh my goodness, too bad. I'm gonna check the wiki again for Slowpoke Well, and double check that, this isn't, hold on. That's not, like, locked by the day kind of a thing. Oops. Yeah, because if I discover, like, yeah, they only show up in the morning, I'm going to be a little frustrated. And I will sit here and I will change my clock. Just, what? And Heart Gold and Soul Silver, there's a 5% chance that it will hold. Oh, geez, I'm actually really hurt. No, you bitch. No, you're a bitch. No, you're a bitch. There you go. Fuck you. Alright, Soul Pokeball. Wait, hold on. So, Soul Silver. Nope, it is not dependent on the time of day. It is just 15% chance. Level 6 to level 8. However, if you surf, it's 100% chance. And it has a 5% chance of holding a lagging tail. Let's see. Forces the holder to move the last in his priority bracket, regardless of its speed. Interesting. That might be a move more for, like, to switch it onto someone else kind of a deal. You know what I mean? Also, what... say, what is up with this? What is up with the Zubat? This guy is a freaking champ. There you go. Oh, still, dude, he's still kicking. This guy is still kicking. Hold on. Oh my goodness. Thank you. Jeez, that guy was rough and tumble. Sure, forget a move. Alright, I'm gonna argue Tail Whip isn't as useful as Poison Powder, because statuses are really nice. So, like, generally speaking, when it comes to Pokemon, I would much rather put a status on someone than I would lower their stats, with the exception of if I can do it for free, like with moves like Intimidate, or with abilities like Intimidate. And like I said before, Stun Spore is my favorite one. 100%. Lower the speed, make it so that they can't do anything 50% of the time. Perfect. I'm gonna pump that. Like, everyone's gonna get confused. Who was that Pokemon? See, this is what I do when I don't have, like, a specific conversation to think about. And I'm being told to just, like, grind at something. I'll make up things to talk about. Whimsicott! Cottonee and Whimsicott, introduced in Gen 4. God, really, a lot of Pokemon in Gen 4 are my favorite. Yeah, it's, what is, let's see, Whimsicott is, pretty well-rounded, a little bit more defense than anything, but mostly speed. Whimsicott's are super fast, and yeah, that's why I remember it, because they can learn Gust, Hurricane, Moonblast, Mega Drain, Razor Leaf, Sunny Day, Cotton Spore, which is kind of fun. I think that just boosts your defense. Stun Spore. But the big thing about them is their ability that I love, called Prankster. Prankster increases the priority of status moves by one. A status boost used by Pokemon Prankster now can be blocked by Quick Guard. Let's see. In Gen 7, let's see, Dark-type Pokemon are now immune to opposing Pokemon moves that grant priority due to Prankster, including moves called by moves that call other names, such as Assist and Nature Power, and excluding moves that repeat as a result of Prankster affected Instruct. Let's see. Blah, 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 blah. Yeah, so looking at this, moves like Attract, a bunch of the powders, things like that. Yeah, Prankster's just really good in general. Because that plus one priority, let's see, Cotton Spore. Oh, lowers the target speed by 2 stages and has accuracy of 85, which raises to 100. That's not bad. There's nothing wrong with that kind of move. Oh, sorry. Yeah, the ability to, like, pretty much guaranteed slap a Stun Spore on someone before they can do anything is, like, yeah, it's pretty great. And then if you can somehow get it onto someone that knows Spore, for example, like, that could get really mean really quickly kind of a thing. Because it's, like, plus one priority and you're asleep. I don't know if this is, like, the only area where I can, like... Tunsil Poke! Ugh. Oh my goodness! This is what we're doing now. But, like I said, on the upside, this is a really good opportunity for Bulyo to train. So, I am completely cool with this. Just in general, I am completely cool with this. There you go. Oh, come on. There you go. Rock on, Bulyo. You're doing awesome. It's not the fastest experience, but, you know, we're getting there. We're getting there in little chunks. You're getting bigger and beefier. Before you know it, you're going to actually, like, run around. You're going to run around water, like, water types and just crush them. I'm almost out of tacos. I think after this one, we'll run back, heal, come back. Want you to be as buff as possible. I mean, Quilava's level 14, right? Quilava was our lowest level one earlier, so. God, I can't wait till we get an experience share. I'll make this so much easier. And then we can still focus people, too. By, like, having, you know, we'll start with someone and then switch them out, but with the experience share on, so they guarantee you get all the experience kind of thing. Yeah, if you're gonna be the last one I fight, I'm not gonna worry about healing. Oh, shit. Oh, come on. Switch. That reminds me, what am I gonna do when I finally get a Slowpoke? I'll probably switch to Quilava and use Ember. Probably. Because if I remember correctly... Slowpokes are tanky little dudes. They're super slow, but they're like, they're tanky, they hit hard, they're just solid. And then weirdly enough, the Slowking version, yeah, if I remember correctly, and I could totally be wrong about this, once again, to the Google machine, as long as, you know, we're not doing anything. Is it dead? Yeah, it's dead. Zubat Fantas, Slowpoke. Let's see. Okay, evolves into Slowbro at level 37 or Slowking when traded holding a King's Rock. And we're not doing that shit. We're not. Cause yeah, between the two is I'm using my right hand, left hand. Let's see. Okay, there we go. Here we go. Yeah, so let's see. They both have, between Slowbro and Slowking, their base stats, right? Yeah, because obviously when I say they're generally speaking this, that is their base stats, which I don't know if that's base stats at level 100 or EV or however they calculate it. Let's see. Minimum stats are calculated with 0 EVs, IVs, and if applicable, a hindering nature. Maximums are with 252 EVs, IVs, blah, 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 blah. Alright. So let's see. They both have an attack of... both have HP of 95... They both have an attack of 75. Oh my goodness, they're the exact same. Slowbro and Slowking are the exact same, except for Slowbro has 110 defense and 80 special defense, and Slowking has 80 defense and 110 special defense. Wow, I forgot just how similar they are. Like, why is there even a difference? And then this is from... Let's go off Ultra Sun, Ultra Moon, just for sake of simplicity. Let's see. So I gotta get him. Gotta get him over there. Sorry, Hotbip. Hang on. Can I jump in this side? Oh, I can. Sick. Alright, let's see. Looking at them both. They both get things like Heal Pulse, Curse. Looks like Slowking gets moves like Power Gem and Hidden Power, which are... Power Gem is pretty cool, but Hidden Power is kind of lame. But let's see. It looks like Slowbro, on the other hand, gets more water-related moves, like Withdraw. Water Gun, Confusion, Disable, Headbutt, Water Pulse, then Headbutt. Slowking gets Nasty Plot, which is pretty cool. But Slowbro gets Swagger, which is kind of funny. Kind of wish you could Swagger yourself. That'd be pretty sick. Slowbro also gets Amnesia, it looks like, which is pretty cool. But Slowking gets Trump Card, which means the internet will hate him. Oh, and Slowbro gets Rain Dance, which is kind of cool. And then I could go through all their TMs, but they look mostly the same. Slowbro gets Aerial Ace, which is pretty good. Pretty good move. Belch, Belly Drum. Belch, Belly Drum, Lock Stomp. Belch Bear. They really are incredibly similar. Like, are their abilities any different? Or, like, are those basically the same, too? Oblivious or Own Temple. Yeah. And then their hidden ability is Regenerator, which, if I remember correctly, is just every time they switch out, they get 33% of their health back. Yeah. Regenerator restores 1/3 of the Pokemon's maximum HP. Which is honestly kind of a cool ability. Especially if you have a lot of moves like U-Turn and Volt Switch and stuff like that. But, Trump Card. Trump Card inflicts damage and bypass accuracy checks to always hit unless the target's in. See, Trump Card's power depends on the move's remaining PP after you. Ha 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 ha. PP. Wahaha. No one could resist making that joke. Let's see. So it starts at 5. But if it has 4 or more, it's 40, 3 is 50, 2 is 60, 1 is 80, and then 0 is 200. So if it's like the final time it uses it, it hits like a truck kind of a thing. It's an uncommon move, interesting. There's not very many Pokemon learn it. Like I said, if I have nothing to talk about, I will make up my own stuff to talk about, and it will likely be uninteresting. As long as you're Googling things, let's Google more things. Oh, you bastard. You suck. You suck. Burp. That's right, I snapped out my confusion. Okay, hold on. Green shard. What is it? I'm sorry.
I'm okay now. I'm okay.
Let's see. Green shard is a type of item introduced in Generation 3. It is one of the shards. Let's see. Looks like they're... Oh my god! Oh shit! I see on my screen over there! It's a girl! This is an all-boy team. I won't tolerate this, Namkin. I was about to say catch that bitch. It's like... Let's see. It looks like... Oh, exchange one with the juggler in Violet City for a berry. You can exchange them for berries or sell them for, like, nothing. That's depressing. That kind of sucks. So it's a berry. Aren't they normally, like, 1,000 gold or something like that? Oh, you're so fucking cute. Oh, I'm catching your butt. I'm catching your delightful butt. Yawn! Oh, no, you're a bastard. Oh, no. Yawn is such a cool move. Because, like, okay, so it takes a turn to work. Oh, my goodness, you know, curse. I love it. Yeah! And I'm asleep. Yawn is guaranteed sleep, but it takes a turn. Which is a fun ability. Alright, bag. Pokeballs. I could use a fastball. That makes it easy to catch a fastball. A lure? Nah, ah, oh, god. If I had a dusk ball, I would've... Can you switch Pokeballs this game? I remember that being introduced at some point in time. Okay. What generation of Pokemon could... You change the Pokeball. Could you change the Pokeball? Can you change a Pokemon's Pokeball? What? That's bullshit. Can you seriously not change it? What? Through in-game means.
What?
Ah, that is depressing. Cause yeah, if I could, everyone would be eating either dusk or netballs because they look cool. A sweet sap leaks from his tail tip. Although not atrocious, the tail is pleasant to chew on. Yes. Okay, so I said if it was a girl, I name her Enid. But I think I'm going to stick with Grant. Wait, hold on. Gernid. How about Gernid? Gernid. Gardein. Gernid. Welcome to the team, Gernid. Welcome to the mother-loving team. We are excited to have you. A naive nature, but proud of its power. Prevents it from becoming infatuated. You had a better ability. It was oblivious or own tempo. Oh, own tempo prevents you from being confused. Damn it, that would have been good. But yeah, you can see he's just physical wall. Curse, yawn, tackle, and growl. Pretty good, honestly. Like curse is a good time. Unable. I was gonna say, like, I'm actually genuinely tempted. Rock Tomb? Unable. What about Roost? Nah. Fuck yeah. We got our boy. It's a girl. Look, okay, I refer to everyone as my boy and man. What if another one popped up and it was a boy?
I'd be like, shit. Am I a sexist pig? Today I might be a sexist pig just so I can say my boy.
Yep, Gurnid. And then I can close my one window.
Yeah.
Wait, I just realized I'm confused and asleep. What the fuck? Pull.
It's not a status move, but it's pretty much a status move.
Bullshit. Oh my goodness. Gurnid. Gurnid, how could you do this to me? Gurnid. Gurnid, there's this adorable sleeping pixie, and it is just sitting there and getting its blood just... Ah, yep, there it goes. I'm awake now, bitch! Meh. The thing is just like gnawing on its neck and just wakes up like, you what? Alright, snap out of that confusion. Ah, oh, come on. Nah, damn it. I bet I can... Nope, switching you out. Switching it. Nope. Quilava, get in there, because Gurnid's hurt. Yeah, suit of snoop. Okay, yeah, fuck your suit. Let's fuck your supersonic. There you go. Just take that. There you go. Goodbye. Okay. Everyone's safe. Everyone's good. Let's get out. We're never coming back to this cave. We got our water type. We're good. Now, granted, it does not know a water type move. So, it's kind of... Hold on. So, yeah, you're level 13. That's pretty good. That's what I want. I just want Granted to fall. Oh, you're so cute! I know it's like, Max, there's these slow pokes right here, but... Aww, Gurnid is dizzy. No, Gurnid, you're not feeling well. It's probably because I just kicked the shit out of you and brought you out of your normal habitat or whatever. It's fine. Let's go. Let's go, you adorable little bastard. I think this series is going to be... It's going to be a lot of Pokemon that I don't normally use, but that I really like. You know what I mean? Oh, also, which reminds me, Professor Elm said, bring, let's get Bolio to level 15, and then we'll start on Gurnid. Cause, Elm wanted me to come back, but I would have to go through a cave, I'd have to go through all of Route 32, I'd have to go through a lot. Nah, I'm good, I'm not worried about it. It's like, ba-ding! I'm like, shit. Tell me something. Is it true that Team Rocket has returned you? Yeah, you're lying. Let's see how good you are. Oh, shit. Schlapper's gonna come here and kick your little American ass. Ah, shit. I was really hoping it was Totodile. That would be funny. He's like, let's go, bitch. Alright, yeah, you're a poison type, so nothing I do is gonna help with that. Let's switch you out and put in... Wooked in. Foresight! This is gonna be the one time I ever use Foresight, like, legitimately. You can't do shit against me. You thought you were hot shit. You're like, I got a great idea. I'm gonna walk in... You know what? You do that. Hey, look, it's Bolio! He's like, what is Bolio gonna do against me? Oh, yeah. That's right, I foresighted you. Oh, I'm sorry, what are you gonna do against me? Oh, no, of tackle? You mean the move that has, like, 35... Okay. Okay. Boom. Look at all that delicious experience. Yeah, I'm gonna have to switch him out though. Which is gonna be a little unfortunate. Oh, whatever. Fucking whatever. It's level 16 though. Pritka. Dude, send in Sudasnoop. Send in Sudasnoop. There you go. Have this. Nope, don't give a shit. How about this? Blech. Yeah. Ooh. He's actually learned a combat move. Impressive. Oh no. Oh. Oh no. Ooh. Ooh. You're done. You're done. Suck it. Yeah, that's right, Schlappa. I'm using you to grind. Boom. I don't learn Flame Wheel yet. Crokina? Shit! That thing is level 18. I'm suddenly not feeling so confident. I think you got this. Shit. 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 And he's faster. Nope. I'll say this ain't gonna kill him. This is bad. This is really bad. This is really bad. This suddenly got really bad. Cause poison bug, right? Oh, never mind. Fury attack. Just solid damage. Oh my goodness, we're beefy. That's fine. That's fine. Think you're hot shit. I can lose to a wimp like you, ah, shit. Great, yeah, go for it. You're already faster than me. Do it again, I dare you. Make my speed -6. But, this is scary because Quilava can't go in. Chidin can't go in. I think you're dead. Wow, you're dumb. You're dumb. Please don't miss. Son of a bitch. You heard me. He's straight up. Oh, God. I say he straight up heard me. And I was like, wow, you're dumb. He's like, bitch. He's like, oh, shit. Oh, God. That was bad, yeah. Because he, yeah, freaking, actually, oddly enough, he's tankier than he is. Wow, he's actually kind of tanky. All considered. Yes. That would have been, yeah, poison powder. Fuck poison powder. Yeah, that would have been my hope if I had to keep him in, would be to just sit there and would have been just to sit there and paralyze him and then hope for the best. Oh, Russian voice. Listen, you won only cause my Pokemon. Okay, here your money. I leave now. I hate the weak. It doesn't matter who or what. I hate to see them hang around. They think they are big and tough as long as they in group, but get them alone and they're weak. I hate them all. If you get in my way. Wow, okay. Well, I just whooped your ass, but, you know, no big deal. Use my... There's a time and place for everything, but not now. High five, team. Y'all were beautiful. Y'all, every one of you did wonderful. He thought he was gonna, like, do some hot shit with having a freaking whatchamacallit. With having a Ghastly, he Ghastly killed himself, which was hilarious. And yeah, everyone did great. And Chidin's like, I didn't do anything. And we're like, you didn't need to. Is it becoming the Ivanin? Yeah, we'll just catch a Paris and we'll call it good. Far-fetched that cut trees. Ah! Oh! Man, I'll take a far-fetched. It seems to face the direction of the noise when you step on a branch. Ah, shit. Hopefully I won't notice this and I'll just start beating the shit out of Paris. Oh, you got this. It's a freaking Weedle. You got this. Boom. Yeah, jeez, that thing was level, like, that Croconaw was level 18. That was kind of, because, yeah, my highest level guy is 17, and it was a ground type, so it's like, this could turn really bad really quickly. Wow. Oh, there's one more missing. I was gonna say, like, that was super easy. Nah, shit. Alright. I don't care about Kakuna. Blue, blue, boo, boo, bagoo. Tackle for freaking days. A bit of battle of attrition, but we can do this. Have I said I'm excited yet? Oh, connecting. For a second, we might be disconnecting a little bit, but it's fine. How frantic are you? Hello, Gloomy Shroomy. I'm pretty frantic. I have to remember how this puzzle works. Pretty frantic against the, against Faulkner, but we're well past him now. Yeah, so I have to remember how this puzzle works. Cause if I run at him face on, cause you have to be behind him. Yeah, so yeah, you have to be behind him. So yeah, so run. You need to catch from behind. I'm aware. If you're our stream, I don't know either. Oh, but yeah, been going for 3 hours. Gonna end soonish though. We're gonna catch this far-fetched, go a little longer because I have an engagement at 6 that I must attend to. That for sake of personal information, I will not state what it is. But yeah, sorry. Normally I stream, and I promise this isn't me just shilling myself because I hate shilling myself. You're getting engaged. Nah, I'm kidding. I was gonna be like, close. Okay, so. There you go. Is this close enough? Nope. Well then, what the fuck? Hold on. Yeah, because if I go that way, I'll go back to the corner. So what, do I just need to follow it? And if I follow it, does it, like, loop around to its own little place? Or is it just gonna... Okay, fine, I'll come at you this way, then. Well, then... Because if I... I'm just imagining this bug just like launches. I've killed so many of your brethren. But what was I gonna say? Chilling myself. Normally I stream from like 4 to 7 and then I tend to go late to like, I tend to go to 8 or 9, even though I say 4 to 7. On Monday, Wednesday, and Friday, but this week is a little bit different, just on the grounds of not gonna be available Friday either, but big scheme, but that's Admiralty. Normally I start and end a bit later. Just today is a little bit, this is too bad. So you missed this, Klooma Shroomy. You missed this, but I wanted to catch a Slowpoke. I'm doing a Nuzlocke, but I'm changing some of the rules just for funsies, and one of them is I have a mascot Pokemon of Slowpoke, which is why I have it up there, and also over there. But I was just killing Zubats endlessly, and this bullshit right here. This bullshit. It was just this. Endlessly. Them confusing me and dying. So that's why I see that Zubat, I'm like, this motherfucker. Right, so it goes back up. Okay, so I feel really stupid about this, so if I hit the branches, I'll look at him dead on, and he'll go down. I'm feeling really stupid right now. Hang on. Yeah, because he runs that way, and then he looks that way. But if I go from the bottom, he's going to go back that way. So the only other option is to go from the top, and no matter what, I have to hit these branches, unless... it is delayed? Ah, jeez, I'm sorry. It might help if you refresh, because I have it set on the fastest possible, and I haven't received any errors about, I haven't received any errors that, like, I cut out temporarily and came back in. And it's too late in the stream for me to, like, restart the whole stream for it. So, I don't mean that as a screw you, but it's like, it might help if you refresh. Or have a lower, graphics setting. You refresh? I don't know what to tell you, and I feel like a big old jerk. Just know that I'm trying to read everything you say. Hopefully it's not too bad. But, yeah, that's one of those things that I've been trying to, like, fight with for a while, and I've not been able to figure anything out. In the past... It's better? It's better. Okay, good. Yeah, sometimes there's, like, that lag, and that, like... Instead of you skipping content, it'll just delay the content for you. And, yeah, it's a little iffy and weird, but, you know, it's how it works. And I endeavor to bring the best service that I can... Poison. It's fine. Not like I'm trying to train my boy here. Not like I want. It's a little faster. Well, I'm saddened to hear that, but I don't know what to tell you, to be 100% honest. Here at LordEctro Industry. Almost. It's like it's like 1 minute? Oh god, what would it cost that? Oh no. Yeah, oh no indeed. Oh wait, you might be referring to the poison. Yeah, we're gonna start getting Gurnet in there, cause man, frickin' Bullyops, he's almost. There you go. 1 minute to 30 seconds. We're gonna end soon anyway. Cause yeah, the only fix for me that, the only fix I found in the past for me that worked with that. Well, we try, man. We try. To say your technical issues. Alright, whose worthless butt am I gonna give this to? Alright, I'm gonna give it to Mother Lovin', probably the Beedrill, to be honest. Let's see, Buddha contain cut, teach cut, yes please. Okay, who can learn it? I actually like what to get put on the starter. Yes, put it on the start now, put it on Beedrill, because I don't give a shit about Beedrill. That's not true, I actually really like Beedrill. Let me just write something down real quick. Paris, ? We'll get rid of Harden. Hardin's dumb. And really, actually, it probably would beat out Fury Swipes in terms of power. So I probably could have just put him on Fury Swipes. Yeah, whatever, it's fine. Nah, I'm getting poisoned. Let's get the heck out of here, children. All Beedrill should die. Dang. Like, I have a soft spot for all the bugs. It's just, in terms of, like, my current team, like, who do I have an emotional attachment towards? Beedrill is not a... Yeah, it's whatever, Polio. Like, yeah, in terms of who on my team do I have emotional attachments for, it's not Beedrill. Just straight up, it's not. The Geodude and the Sentret. Yes, I am weird. I like bugs. I think bugs are cool. Except for spiders. I have an issue with spiders. Otherwise, I think bugs are cool. Like, I was talking to some people earlier. For funsies sometime, or at least I think this is fun. I could be totally wrong. 300% us. Play Pokemon. Play around a Pokemon. Bug-type Pokemon are gross. that's fair. I can't argue with that. But for funsies sometime, I would implore you... Let's switch out this. Let's get Bolio that one level, and then we'll... And then we'll focus on Gurnid to get everyone to level 15. Should be fine. Screw you, man. But, do a round of... They're almost always weak starting Pokemon. That's something I never really liked, personally. I feel like they get a bad rap because of that. But there are a lot of cool bugs, so... To finish my thought, I would implore you to, some point in time, start a game of Pokemon and only use bugs. Like, yo, it doesn't have to be a Nuzlocke. They can die however many times you want or whatever, but just only use bugs. It's fun. It's, like, honestly a lot of fun. I really enjoy it. Is this going to be like this game, that game from Mario Party with the tubes? I bet it is. Hang on. Well, actually, wait, they'll all probably get me there. Called it. Okay, so that teaches me the mechanics of it. Hi. Good, I wanted to fight you. Charms of bug Pokemon. Yeah! Like, I know, like you said, if you think bug Pokemon are, like, weak or, you know, they're just not your thing at all. Would it know bug bite? Would it know bug bite? It should not. Bug Bite you get at level 15? Level 15 or 20? I could be wrong. I don't remember for sure. I'm pretty sure Bolio's safe. I'd be amazed if Bolio wasn't safe in this fight. If it was a Weedle, I'd switch him out. But for right now, this is kosher. This is fine. Especially if all of it's doing is string shotting for some glorious reason. But yeah, like a run with just only Pokemon. Polio is insane. The Polio, the one where, you know, little Timmy Christmas story. Anyway, but I know, like doing that run, it was a lot of fun and it gave me a lot more appreciation for bug types in general. However, you will probably find yourself using Pokemon like Pinsir, Scyther, Heracross, you know, like the big boy bugs. But, yeah, I don't know. I had a lot of fun doing it. You might as well. If not, yeah, it's fine. Not everyone has to like the same kind of Pokemans. Okay, that's a problem. That's a problem. Yep, now we're running. You can switch in Gurnid, I bet it can survive one hit. Nah, let's just switch in Mapritkup. Like, this is what you're gonna be when you grow up. He's like, ah, shit. I didn't think you'd bring a bug to a bug type gym. That's right, cut. Yes, they do. Everyone has to love the same Pokemon. That Pokemon. Yep, I was about to say, like, it's Gen 1, ain't it? It's Charizard, Alakazam, Gengar, Dragonite. If I had to make a bet on the Pokemon that everyone has to love, it's always those four. Which is, generally speaking, why I try to avoid using Gen 1 Pokemon if I can, just because they're so overused. I'm a little bit of a hipster that way. I feel like I've turned into a bug Pokemon. You do that. I'm leaving. Oh, yeah, Pikachu, too. Ah, Pikachu. Yep, Mewtwo, you are absolutely right there. I did not consider that. All right, let's switch in Gurnid. Actually, thinking about it, I think everyone... Did I do my math right? Yeah, I did my math right. I think everyone on my team here is going to be pretty good against all the bugs, so I feel... feeling confident. So they get stronger that much faster. Okay. Here's a belief I have in Pokemon that is fundamentally incorrect, and I will admit it that it is fundamentally incorrect. Nah, let's keep you safe for now. Let's keep you safe. Let's keep you safe. You got plenty more fights I want you to get through. Mapricka. Let's send him Mapricka. Yeah, even the gym leader Scyther, exactly. But, this is something I recognize that they can't do in Pokemon, but it bothers me conceptually, that there are Pokemon that are just fundamentally, no matter what you do, stronger than other Pokemon. And, like, I get it. You can't have everyone be exactly equal. Yeah, you're level 9, so you can... you can do stuff. I'm gonna switch to Gurnid and then switch back. We're trying to power level him, essentially. He's so cute! He's so fucking cute! I love him! Man, you wanna fuck with him real quick? You wanna fuck with the Kakuna? There you go. This probably won't work. Curse. Social Darwinism. But yeah, like, I understand why they can't have Pokemon all be of the same power in certain regards. There will inevitably be Pokemon that are stronger than others, and the stronger than others are worse than others. But, by the same token, you want to fuck with the Kakuna. But by the same token, I don't know, it kind of stinks when it's like, hey, no matter what, okay, wasn't expecting that. Alright, and also screw dealing with that nonsense. I did all that for nothing. We're gonna switch into Pseudosnip. We're just gonna light it up on fire. But, yeah, I'm not dealing with that. Nope. Here you go. It was fun as a bit, but god, I didn't want to sit there for 3 hours. But, what was I gonna... Ooh. I'm a cheating bastard. Doo-da. But, yeah, it does kind of stink, though, that they make a big deal about that there's bugs that evolve sooner so that they're stronger. But then even when they do fully evolve, it's not like they're even any better than the other Pokemon. So it's like their whole mechanic that they're like... this is a big deal, and let me tell you why. Really isn't. Flame Wheel? No Flame Wheel, okay. Maybe Flame Wheel is when I get to Typhlosion. I don't remember. You have to move the web using the Switch. Ah, I see. So if I do it right now, it'll get me to the, it'll get me to that double battle. Which, how hurt is everyone? They're fine. It's fine. I'm doing this on purpose. This is really cute, though. Double battle me! Double battle! Please don't be a single battle. I want a double battle. Yeah, look at that! Look at that, they got the two cute bugs! They're so cute! They're so cute! I'm gonna try to keep Gurnid in this battle. I think Gurnid's gonna do great. And meanwhile, Sudasnoot is just gonna do the work. Yep, Gurney is like, I'm just gonna sit here and curse and get all buff, and Sudasnoot is just. Yep. Thank you for attacking Sudasnoot. I appreciate it. Your face showed temporary disappointment for a second.
Yeah.
All right.
I know.
I mean, it's because it was a spider. Just. But
Yeah, double battle.
What were their names? Pim and Mimi? That reference? I think that's it. Oh, no. Ah, shit. Can you imagine being the bug, whatever his name is, and just watching me go back and forth slowly? It's like, ah, sorry, hang on. It's like, okay, there we go. Anyway, sorry, excuse me. Yeah, I know you're there, but just hang on, sir. Excuse me. I'm just gonna go over here and just there you go, and then just excuse me. He's just watching me do this, like, ah, jeez, I can't believe this kid.
I did save all the Slowpoke. They're right here.
See, trainers and gym puzzles look like asses. Well, do you mean like the NPC trainers, or do you mean like me going through them looking like an ass? Because I would believe both of them. Alright, yeah, I'll send him a Pritka. You're probably going to try to use a Stun Spore or something. And you might have Fury Cutter or Leech Life. Let's see. All trainers ever. Everyone just looks like a big old turd. Which, to that I say, yeah, probably. I mean, we challenge each other just by locking eyes, so clearly this isn't a very friendly society that we live in. All of them, down the line. No prejudices to be found, just all of them. Ooh. Look at you and you're having a separate move just for me. That's a cool cry. I like that cry. It's a nice boulder. Alright, so. So now I gotta take this back. And then I gotta do this. Okay, so I could go back and heal, but they'll probably reset the puzzle. But they won't reset the trainer fight, so for sake of. I wish I could cry like. So you say that, it's like, now I have concerns. Alright, yeah, that's fine, yeah. I want that experience. I think I'll grind with Slowpoke off camera. And if anyone dies, I'll be honest and say, like, yep, they died. Let's go. I'm Bugsy! I never lose when it comes to Bug-type Pokemon. Authority, studies, let's fight.
He's so freaking cute. Holy shit.
I'm scared. Chidan, we're getting there. It's a fucking Scyther. Holy shit, we're gonna die.
U-turn.
Oh fuck.
What?
I know you told me, but still. That's what I thought.
Hee.
Oh no, I know. I know. I know. That'll be fine. Three is fine. Hee 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 hee. Think you're hot shit just cause you're like, oh yeah, look at me. Oh yeah, look at me. I could use U-turn and yippity-doo-dah out of there. What are you gonna do about it? To which I say... I feel justified in using an item to heal. He did it. He did it. He's a bitch. He's a bitch. I didn't use items mid-battle to heal. Twitch stream makes people go insane. A little bit. Yeah, Chidan, get that experience. Oh, wait. Oh, you have another one, though. Ah, oh, damn it. You're gonna rock throw your ass. Was your time's 4 weeks this, right? Bye-bye. Oh, you thought you were so clever. I really wish that experience could have gone to... the Gurnid. Really wish. But you know what? It's fine. No! No! Mm-mm! Mm-mm! Keep all moves. This is a Nuzlocke. Mm-mm! Give up on self mm-mm! 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 Bug Pokemon are tough. You're absolutely right. They are. If this kills me, I'm gonna throw a fit. I was gonna say, does it poison me? Ah, beautiful. Granted, I'm three levels higher. Chidan is a physical powerhouse. But he was gonna do some bullshit. Cause I'm willing to bet if for whatever reason, Scyther was hurt, he would have taken the time with Metapod and Kakuna to like heal up his dudes. Kind of a thing, to heal up Scyther so that Scyther can kill, like, keep U-turning, because U-turn hits hard, if I remember correctly. So, them doing that, and then me going, like, you know what, bitch? I could play that game and just sit there and just heal up, like, sit there and just get all buff. Obviously, it wasn't necessary since I one-hit everything, but, you know, it made me feel Bugsy's a girl. Damn it! I am sexist, misgendered asshole! Well, okay, in my defense, I don't know. They didn't refer to themselves as a gender or something. I didn't know.
What's it?
Well, now I know Bugsy's a girl. U-turn! It is great!
Are deep, there are many mysteries to explore. Study your top choices thoroughly. I will, thank you. Thank you, miss.
As Clumy Shroomy has informed me. God, I feel bad when I misgender things. It's not on purpose, I promise.
Yes, it is on purpose. It's not. Mm-mm. Not on purpose.
Promise.
Screw you. I'm out.
Hey, actually, wait, hold on. Oh. Certified trainer, Max. Hey! Oh, I was hoping they'd have, like, Schlappa's name on it. Apparently that... I thought that Bugsy was a girl my entire life. Apparently that's wrong. So, is Bugsy a girl or a boy? I need confirmation. Also, someone tried to call me, and I missed it. So I'm gonna go through the people I care about, starting with my mother. Mom, what's up? No, I don't want to save money. No, when the stock market crashes, I want to get fucked. Bugsy's not. Okay, I'm gonna be on. I should fact check before I call people. Are you serious? Serious? That'd be pretty forward. Show me what kind of Pokemon it is. I'll get to you when I have a fast way of getting to you. That'd be pretty impressive considering when this game came out if Bugsy was non-binary. Evaluate my Pokedex, Professor. What does this mean? No, Bugsy's a boy. Bugsy's a boy! Yeah, okay, cool. Because I always thought he was a boy. That's why I was like, whoa. Let's see.
God, I gotta wait a day for him to make my Pokeball.
Alright, so I don't know what that call was, but I assume it wasn't important. Whatever it was. Whatever it was, I'm sure it's fine, probably. Maybe, probably not. This is gonna be a horrible mistake and we're all gonna die. Well, anyways, let's end the episode off. Actually, wait, hold on. Before we end the episode off here, there's one thing? Two things I would like to check really quick. Fix my mustache. All right, the first thing is to go to the bag and look at our new, we have U-turn and, I just wanna see, cause I'm guessing Beedrill can learn it. Yeah, I'm guessing Beedrill can learn it. Can any, Wookton? Bulio can learn it. I'm intrigued. So yeah, I've never personally been a big fan of moves that switch yourself out just on the grounds of only one Pokemon can learn it. Choose wisely. Yeah, exactly. That's something I love. I love in the new gens that you could just throw them out freely so that everyone can learn it and you don't have to choose one. It's so much more freeing. Because especially with the Nuzlocke, I don't know if one of these Pokemon are gonna die. So if they die, it's like, well... I heard something freak me out. But if they die, it's like, well, you know, fuck me. I just lost whatever.
Netballs are so cool.
Oh, is that water Pokemon? I could have had a netball for freaking... whatchamacallit. But, what am I saying? What am I ever saying?
I'll buy a few, just in case
I'm in like a rush, you know what I mean? And burn heal, we already got a few of those. Antidotes, we got like three. Yeah, we're fine, we got three. Four, yeah, we're fine, we got four. Three, yeah, fine, we got three. Super potions, we don't really need any of them yet, so I'm gonna ignore that. Normal potions, dude, we got 14 of them. Pokeballs, this.
Yeah, there we go.
But, oh!
Gloomy Shroomy, thank you so much for following. Really appreciate it.
Even if you tell me I'm wrong for thinking bug Pokemon are cool.
Goodbye after.
No, I'm kidding. But, I'm not the biggest fan of switching myself out because in my mind, you only have four attack slots, right? You only have four. And you can fill them all with useful things, and if one of them is you're basically trying to escape. I'm toxic. But if one of them is basically you are betting that this is not a situation you want to be in and you wanna leave, that strikes me as a little backwards. You know what I mean? But like that doesn't strike me as like, you know, I don't like surrendering. I don't like surrendering. I like staying in the fight. I don't like giving up kind of a thing. Like, sometimes, yeah, you need to switch around to... because it's strategic, but I don't like giving up. So, that's why I'm, like, a little hesitant when it comes to moves like U-turn. Now, moves that switch the opponent out... like, I know there's Whirlwind and Roar, but... I think there's other moves that can make them switch out, too. I forget. But, moves like that can, if I have, like, spikes... or toxic spikes, or a stealth rock on the ground, and I can make them move out so that they just take damage kind of a thing, that would be really useful. But moving myself out is weird and interesting. Furthermore, we could put it on... hold on, let's just go to the team. Let's go to the team real quick. We can put it on... Furret. The Furret, Beedrill, and... the Furret, Beedrill, and a Hoppip. Hoppip has Tackle and Bullet Seed. and what were the other two moves? Synthesis and stun spore or whatever. So I could remove Toxic. Furret has Fury Swipes, Quick Attack, Foresight, and Growl, I think. Or Tail Whip. We can remove whatever the Growl or Tail Whip is. And Beedrill's Beedrill. We don't give a shit about Beedrill. So that's why I'm sitting here like, this could be really good. But is it worth the switch out? Especially if I'm like buffing my stats or whatever. And am I in control of who I switch in when I use U-Turn? Because it said the next Pokemon on the team. Who's the next Pokemon? What dictates that? That is research I will have to do, because U-Turn sounds like it could be really useful. Sounds like it could be really neat, but that issue is definitely a concern. If I can control who I send in, you are in control? You are in, okay, so if you are in control of who you switch in, okay, so let's see. Yeah, none of these guys I want to put on the team. Not worried about any of them. You think so? Well, I trust you on it. Strategy. These are things that will have to be considered. Actually, I'm going to go outside. Let's see. There we go. There we go. My baby. How's my baby? It's focusing its attention on you. Oh, yeah, baby. Yeah, your baby Slowpoke. He's so cute. I love it. Hold on. Nah, shit. Hang on. Hold on. There we go. It's so cute. Just look at it. Sorry, I love Slowpoke. But, yeah, that definitely throws out some questions on what we should do for our team here. Looking at the end game, I can see myself... Okay, Slowpoke, mascot. Quilava, starter. I can obviously see me rocking those the entire game. Hoppip? Probably? I can see myself doing it. Bam, new profile, basically. But, actually, can I change my Pokemon profile in this game? Can I do that? Oop, ah, damn it. I have failed the motherland. There we go. Can you do anything with that? Touch card to flip. Huh. I can sign it? How many people drew penises on it? Anyway, but, okay, this team that I have right now, I feel like I would at least want to switch out Beedrill, but for the most part, I could see myself rocking this team for a long time. That's why I'm like, I could totally put U-Turn on one of them, but who should I put U-Turn on? I may have to cheat a little bit and look at their movesets. Many people just fucking knew it. What was I saying? I may have to cheat and look at their movesets in the future to be like, oh my goodness, all these moves suck, so screw it, throw U-Turn on it. Or maybe the inverse will happen, where I'll put U-Turn on someone and then be like, oh my goodness, they have four amazing moves that are way better than U-Turn that I want to put on. And it's not worth having it be a temporary fix. You know what I mean? So it's going to be thinking that out. I think also off camera, no guarantees if I will get to it, but I will try to. I'm going to try to level everyone up to, let's just arbitrarily say level 18, just to give a good, like, base mark kind of a thing. So that'll be, Chidane is fine, but yeah, Woodkin, Mpritka, Bolio, Sudasnook, Gurnid, all of them will need to be leveled up there. Oh yeah, it is a boys party except for Gurnid. Look at that. Yeah, and I think we're good. Anyways, let's end the episode off here. I'm gonna save my game. Just real quick. I'm gonna save the game. Because we got two gym badges today. We're doing pretty good. Alright, so let's end the episode off here. As I mentioned before, and I think I mentioned last week, this week's streaming schedule is gonna be a little bit weird. So instead of streaming on Monday, Wednesday, Friday like we normally would, I think we'll be streaming on Monday, Tuesday, and Wednesday. However, today was not the normal time. Tomorrow will be. So that will be, yeah, tomorrow, 4 to 7 CST, we will be doing StarCraft 2 cooperative mode. And then on Wednesday, we'll be back in Pokemon SoulSilver Nuzlocke with our fun little silly challenge that I don't necessarily abide by all the time, but you know what? Screw it. We're having fun. Yeah, those are the next times I'll be streaming. Announcements, which will be on Facebook and Twitter, which are in the description below. Violets will be on YouTube as soon as I can, which is I'm having some issues. So, yeah, that'll be someday. And, yeah, we'll end off here. Thank you all so much for watching. I hope you all had fun. Kluma Shroomy, thanks for coming by. I really appreciate it. And, yeah, I will see you tomorrow or then. Hopefully. Yeah. There we go. Thank y'all for coming. Because I'm going to... There. Blah, 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 blah. There we go. Thank y'all for coming. Bye. Bloop.